October 12th, 2016. Danny Williams is in the green room. He's going to be live, the reported son of Bill Clinton. I believe he is the son of Bill Clinton. But first, a key report. Stay with us.
Yeah, that's it. With the gold. I got to use some Tic Tacs just in case they start kissing her. You know, I'm automatically attracted to beautiful. I just start kissing them. It's like a magnet. You just kiss. I don't even wait. And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
Grab them by the... I can do anything.
This latest controversy marks a divide when those who are aware of the CIA-controlled media protecting the interests of the multinational corporate elite's pawn, Hillary Clinton, react in disgust, and the disgust from those who still think that reality is as it seems.
Are we going to hold that to Hillary Clinton, to the things when she apologized? Oh, wait a minute. She never really apologized for insulting the
Yes, and she, if she
either.
Was, if Hillary...
What did you do the day you saw the tape of this man boasting about grabbing
exactly.
a woman's... Period.
Okay. All right.
Will you please stop saying that word? My daughter is listening.
Yeah, you know what, Scotty? Don't tell me you're offended when I say you're not offended when Donald Trump says
exactly.
I'm not running for president. He is.
If only they could just open their eyes for a moment, they would actually see that totalitarianism is warping that accepted reality. George Orwell described totalitarianism as such, a society living by and for continuous warfare in which the ruling caste have ceased to have any real function but succeed in clinging to power through force and fraud. Hillary Clinton is just the latest villain from a long line of mind-controlling ne'er-do-wells that have ruled over the United States since it was inevitably infiltrated by the global elite central bank scam in 1913. Systematically kept in line by methods of manufactured terror.
Building 7, I often hear about. No plane hit Building 7. Why did Building 7 come down? What do you tell people?
What is Building 7?
Building 7.
I have no idea. I've never heard that.
And assassination of the United States' greatest leaders by a shadow government that pretends to misplace trillions of taxpayer dollars only to fund its Luciferian class war domination over humanity.
More money for the Pentagon when its own auditors admit the military cannot account for 25% of what it already spends.
According to some estimates, we cannot track $2.3 trillion in transactions.
$2.3 trillion with a T. That's $8,000 for every man, woman, and child in America. To understand how the Pentagon can lose track of trillions, consider the case of one military accountant who tried to find out what happened to a mere $300 million.
We know it's gone, but we don't know what they spent it on.
What Trump said amounts to nothing. Nothing compared to her husband's rape victims, some of them brutally raped, only to be attacked publicly by Hillary after the deed was done.
She grabbed a hold of my arm and my hand, and she pulls me into her, and she says with this very angry look on her face, which had been so pleasant seconds before, and in a low voice says, "Do you understand everything you do?" And that frightened me. I felt like she knew.
And that she was ripped you.
Yes, and that she was telling me to keep quiet.
Nothing compared to the savagery Middle Eastern women endure and Hillary ignores, only to push the divide and conquer refugee invasion narrative, a fiction that will eventually lead to the rape of thousands of unsuspecting American women and children. Nothing compared to the bodies hidden along Hillary's path to power. Nothing compared to the thousands that have died in the name of Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's rape of Northern Africa due to the conquest of rich men's wars. Perpetual wars fought in the perceived name of freedom and democracy, only benefiting the wealthy that become wealthier by playing both sides, maiming and killing our brave fighting men and women in the process. In fact, what Trump said should actually strengthen your resolve. You see, 11 years ago when Trump said this, he wasn't a politician. He wasn't being groomed and compromised like CIA plant Hillary has been her entire political life. He was just a guy, like so many other guys, just making a joke. If you want to see a sexual predator, take the blinders off and look no further than Hillary's right-hand man. And I'm not referring to the genderless Illuminati sellout, Tim Kaine. John Bound for InfoWars.com.
We'll be back with Danny Williams and more. Max Boot. Booch, a neocon at the Council on Foreign Relations, which admits it operates as a shadow government. Hillary Clinton has said that in four different speeches and written about it in two books. Wrote a big story over the weekend with the headline, "The Alt-Right is Destroying Itself, Listening to Its Own Media." And he said that we were in an echo chamber and that we were failing. When mainstream corporate media is a shadow of its former self, has 6% trust, according to the Associated Press's own research, of itself. I mean, North Korea, the people have more faith in the media. There it is. Republicans are paying the price for their addiction to their own media. And what they do is they sit there and create a perception that we're all crazy and take what we say out of context. But the truth is, the new media, whether it's left-wing, right-wing, libertarian, doesn't matter, is exploding. Mainstream media is corporately funded, but is collapsing. And so if you go look at the news every day, it's always Trump in trouble, Trump to drop out, Trump loses all of his support, Trump can't raise any money. Why, out of the blue, 30-something Republicans turn against him. They were all the same Republicans that said that if you voted for him, the nomination didn't count and that your popular vote didn't count. So they were just waiting within minutes. And Jerry Falwell Jr. actually got calls and met with the top Republicans that warned him 7 weeks ago that this was coming. And he told Trump, well, I mean, of course it's coming. They even said, oh, there'll be, you know, 3 months, 4 months after the nomination for us to still get Trump. And that's what they did. And then, boom, they take this tape, I mean, which is nothing compared to John McCain or Obama or Bill Clinton and their talk. They edit it, they take it out of context, and then it's the end of the world. It's the Trump's resigning, it's over. We heard that three times the last few months for other scandals. Meanwhile, Hillary represents convicted criminals across the board who then get indicted again for things like child molestation. Hillary Clinton makes jokes about it on tape knowing that they were innocent. Hillary represents jihadis. Hillary represents foreign governments. She's everything she says Trump is. She says Trump won't work for U.S. interests. He'll work for his own when she's the one working against U.S. interests. And so then I baited the media a few days ago, and even say it on the tape I am, that Hillary and Obama are literal demons. Now, I was told by protective details, both military and Secret Service, that I said, why do they always have flies landing on them? We saw it happen during the debate. In fact, in the Middle Ages and even in ancient times before that, a fly landing on someone when it wasn't on anybody else was seen as a symbol of death or evil. They would paint them in Middle Age paintings, Dark Age paintings, Renaissance paintings, of a fly on a skull or a fly on a person as a sign of death. There's paintings of Judas Iscariot that betrayed Christ, famous Renaissance paintings, with a fly on him. And so we just said, isn't it archetypal that Hillary's becoming the Lord of the Flies? As the Bible says, the devil's the Lord of the Flies. And then Obama, all over the world, has flies landing on him, and they're not landing on anybody else. They're landing on her. It's archetypal. It's tongue-in-cheek when I say absolute literal demon from hell. She's obviously not an absolute literal, her body, but I do believe in the Bible. I do believe there's evil influence. And obviously Hillary Clinton's an evil person that brags about overthrowing countries and letting jihadis in to murder hundreds of thousands of Christians. And her internal emails show her hatred for the public and the common people and folks that live in their parents' basements and baristas, her own supporters, and her own emails show this. And more are coming out of her hatred for the public. Remember when I came out and I said, we need to know that they're going to try to federalize and take over the election because Trump is so far ahead in all the major internal polls? Obama came out 2 days later and said, oh, that guy in Texas, there's no such thing as election fraud. That's like saying there's no such thing as wildfires or no such thing as daisies or no such things as automobiles. I mean, it's just ridiculous on its face. And then 2 weeks later, they go, emergency, the Russians and others are going to hack all the systems and steal it for Trump. We've got to federalize the elections. And what did I say at the time? I said, watch Homeland Security claiming they're stopping hacks. That will be the hack. And they did exactly as I said. Oh, but the mainstream media is so smart. They come out and go, it's all over for Trump. Alex Jones says we're literal demons. We're devils. Oh, my gosh, isn't it kooky? See, they're all run by CIA people. And there's more anthropologists and sociologists and psychologists in the CIA than there are commandos and historians. And they're all obsessed with knowing the subgroup and seeing us all as, you know, pygmy villagers or something, or you know, ancient Germanic, you know, villagers. They see us as animals, and they're up there calculating our culture and calculating our background and looking at how we operate and keeping us in the dark while they're part of the future. And they say that, the new WikiLeaks emails. It's just full of how they control us and they have all the answers and they know everything. I covered some of those yesterday where they said, we want to keep the public unaware and compliant. Remember that? That's the top of the campaign. So the way they do it is saying, you're a loser, you failed, there's no awakening. You understand, until the day that the United States Army Air Corps dropped two A-bombs, Fat Man and Little Boy, on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, Tokyo Rose was on a super powerful AM transmitter every hour saying, you have lost, your ships have been sunk, your fleets are defeated, it's all over, you're dead. And that's what this is. Now, 20 years ago, they had the upper hand. They were beating us. And I was telling you, we're getting beat. We're in trouble. It's horrible. We got to mobilize. I don't sit here and like try to, like Oprah Winfrey's The Secret, and speak things into reality. You have to take action to do that. And I said over and over again, we have to turn the tide. We have to expose globalism, the puppet masters, not the puppets. They can always replace the puppets, but not the puppet masters. We've got to expose that. I'm going to skip this break. And that's what I did over and over and over again. You did that. Others did it because you could see classical psychological warfare they were using. So Max Boot of the Council on Foreign Relations, the group sworn to create world government and our sovereignty. I mean, every publication they put out every 2 months admits that. They put out stuff 5 years ago saying why we need Al-Qaeda in Syria and admitted our government was financing Al-Qaeda, now known as ISIS. I mean, they hide this stuff in plain view. You can go to Barnes & Noble every 2 months. It comes out, Foreign Affairs. It's on a magazine. It's like a book, a little green book. It's about 200 pages thick. And I sit here and read what they're saying, what they're doing. They think you're so unintellectual that you'll never look into it all and know that I'm not telling you my opinion. I'm telling you word for word what they've said and what they've done and what they stand for. So he talks about the right wing is in an echo chamber. Hey, brother, you're in an echo chamber and you know it. I'm not right wing. I'm a constitutionalist. I'm a patriot. I transcend your left-right system. Now, your modern left is a bunch of fascist, control freak, victim, useful idiot morons who I am exposing with very harsh language to try to shake them out of their mind control stupor of invincible ignorance and wearing their ignorance like it's a, you know, crown of enlightenment. But I'm not here trying to use their ignorance against them. I'm trying to empower them. Because when they're empowered, those of us that are already more enlightened and smarter than they are, we will rise even higher. You can't lower people and not lower yourself. That's a metaphysical rule of the universe. It's natural law that everything's interconnected. And these globalists are like cancer. They think because they take over and dominate because they're evil, they are the enlightened ones and the dominant ones. No, you're the malfunctioning cancer. If I get cancer, you get cancer, and it kills us, the cancer cells die too, don't they? But they're not conscious. They just think, I do whatever I want. I take over whatever I want. I act. That's conquest versus renaissance. Now, I'm going to get into all the big news here, but there are just a wall of stories. Trump is over. Trump's a loser. Trump's an idiot. You know, if you vote for Trump, you lose. He's going to lose. He's 10 points, 20 points, 30 points, 80 points. I mean, I've seen articles where they're saying he's 30 points behind. And then you read the poll, and they're sampling 60% more Democrats than Republicans. I mean, it is getting crazy. Because, again, they think they can put in the methodology of the poll the fact that it's totally fake, but you're too dumb to understand what sampling 46% Democrats and 22% Republicans means. Or sampling 42% Democrats and 19% Republicans. And then Bloomberg comes out and says, well, we're not going to do that. We're only going to sample 10% more. We're more scientific. Or Politico They only sampled 7% more. Oh, and then Hillary was only winning by 2 points in that one. They had him at a dead heat. See, all of America should be flipping out at just the way they're running the polls, the way they turned his microphone off two debates ago, the way they interrupt him 70 times, 40 times, Hillary 6 times, 3 times. When you see something this rigged and the whole corrupt establishment throwing everything it's got at the public, you've got to know that Donald Trump's the man. Doesn't mean he's perfect. Doesn't mean his feet won't have to be held to the fire. But we know with the Clintons, they are the most archetypal, corrupt, out-of-control group that I could possibly imagine. Now, here's what's coming up today. Speaking of censorship, speaking of control, I want to show TV viewers this article right here. This is DrudgeReport.com. CNN boss Jeff Zucker has directly ordered network staff not to cover shocking allegations made by Arkansas resident Danny Williams, the Drudge Report has learned. Williams, who is set to give his first TV interview today on Infowars.com, claims to be Bill Clinton's biological son. Jeff thinks it is a ridiculous hoax, a top CNN source said. I always felt bad about Bill Clinton not wanting to be in my life, Williams explains in the video released Monday. Was it because I was black? Was there something wrong with me? It made me think sometimes, even of suicide. It's not fair, and it's been hurtful. Hillary, please do not deny I exist. I am your stepson. So all of that is developing. But what's the bigger story here? He'll be in studio in about an hour with us. He's in the room right next to us right now. We're about to tweet out photos of he and I during the last break here in the studio. Photo of Danny standing in front of our big TV screen right here with CNN orders blackout on Clinton's son. Now, there it is. Tweeted at Real Alex Jones. And it's not like this guy just popped up like the media is saying. I was on air 21 years ago and interviewed his aunt. I remember interviewing her, Christian church lady. I remember having the Arkansas State Troopers on. I remember hearing about the money being delivered to the little shack, $700 a month, and the Christmas presents until he tried to go to the mansion in Little Rock down the street, a few miles away, and climb the fence and go to the front door and meet Bill Clinton. But Hillary had the state police come out and run him off. Or how his mother ran in with the baby years before when he was a baby. And Bill Clinton, you got to hand it to him, actually had some heart and some soul. And try to take care of his son. If it wasn't his son, why would he do that? Please, Hillary, do not deny I exist. I am your stepson. That is coming up. So how does the media respond? Oh, the head of CNN, Jeff Zucker, just says, I think it's ridiculous hoax. Close quote. So he believes it, just like they said in the last year. Never talk about Hillary's health. Don't let anybody talk about her falling down. Now we know she does. Now we know there's a cover-up. They say, don't talk about all these other things because the head of CNN has told everybody you don't do it. Same thing with MSNBC. So it's our job at InfoWars to break through that electronic Berlin Wall and to force that discussion. Does Alex Jones get demonized? Do I get attacked? Do I get ridiculed by mainstream media? Absolutely. And 15 years ago, that would hurt us. They still had maybe 40% credibility. They have 6% credibility. This is a criminal, deceptive combine that admittedly the WikiLeaks prove even more, get daily directives and talking points. We already know that. And it's the non-talking point media that's only a handful of groups that now has more viewers and listeners than all the giant spectrum of mainstream media that's falling apart. And their answer as they fall apart is to get the wagons closer together. To centralize the control even more. I have a stack of WikiLeaks after the break I'm going to go over that show that. The latest ones. Total control. When she's on CNN, when she's on MSNBC, there is a teleprompter behind the reporter. He's asking prepared questions. She is responding in a totally scripted event. We already knew that from the emails. Now it comes out that the whole thing's scripted. Word for word. Actors, actresses at her events, fake town halls. When she does have real ones, people show up behind her with Bill Clinton rape shirts. Obama goes out in public yesterday. Three people over 20 minutes pop up and say Bill Clinton's a rapist and expose it. He then goes into the whole diatribe that, oh, this demonization campaign, this talk show host he wouldn't name, but everybody in the news, CNN, you name it, you know, Alex Jones, says I'm literally a demon and stink. Well, I mean, I asked people, why are there always flies landing on you and Hillary? And they said, oh, we don't know what it is, but they both smell. And they didn't say sulfur. They actually said, like SH, you know what? I don't know what's going on with you people, but hey, Mao Zedong reportedly stunk so bad, even when he was young. No, look it up. Lenin totally stunk. These people just, I guess they don't care about anybody, so they don't even take baths or something. I don't know. The point is that she funds jihadis worldwide, kills hundreds of thousands of Christians. That's demonic. They fund abortuaries selling 8th and 9th month baby parts. They keep the babies alive while they butcher them. They try to cover up that. Obama hates bitter clingers on the Bible and the guns. But the most interesting part is they say, how dare them become so mean and vitriolic? They say, we're doing that because we're losing. No, we defeated you trying to block the Tea Party Liberty Movement. It's surging. You know it. You actually admit that in your internal WikiLeaks. We covered it yesterday. They admit we're winning. They're losing. So what do? They say, we're being mean. You say that half of the Trump supporters are deplorable racists. Then you say, I'm racist with no history or no statement of that. You then say, your surrogates on CNN, MSNBC, ABC say, actually, all Trump supporters are deplorable. Trump supporters are attacked nationwide, physically. Trump towers are firebombed, vandalized on a weekly basis. You call us all sorts of horrible names. You say, if we don't support Obamacare, that's a giant screw job. That we're racists. All of that's okay. All that's okay. But then we stand up for ourselves, and you again try to dictate the rules. So this is about a facade media that has almost no viewers, no listeners, getting together and just creating the hoax. The only power they have is that they are so lockstepped, so they put out the exact same talking point. And even though people don't trust mainstream media, when they see it in 100 newspapers and 10 different networks, all said in the same way, and they've got MSNBC, CNN, ABC, NBC, CBS going, Bill Clinton never settled sexual assault cases. Bill Clinton never, even though he settled like four of them, people start questioning, kind of like, there is no death panel on Obamacare. It is free. You can keep your doctor. And then people started getting the fines. The price went up. You learned it was a screw job. And then they were so arrogant, Gruber and others, the architects, would go on C-SPAN and say, thank God the public's so dumb. Now they have celebrations on Charlie Rose's show saying, thank God they're so dumb. We told them you can keep your doctor. And all the sick little lawyers in a club, these young punk lawyers that help write it, brag to Rose that they helped screw the American people because they don't think you watch Charlie Rose. See, criminals want to celebrate the criminal action in their own criminal organization. This is criminology. So that's why there's all these videos of the head of the State Department spokesperson, you know, saying, ha, 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 thank God we're so corrupt, they're so dumb. That's why you see Gruber saying it. It's why you see these celebrations is because, we played the videos last week, is because they want to rub it into you. Remember the top WikiLeaks from their top advisor to Hillary, Mr. Ivey. He says, as I've mentioned, we've all been quite content to demean government, drop civics, and in general conspire to produce unaware and compliant citizenry, he writes. He's serious. He goes, when the unawareness remains strong, but compliance is obviously fading rapidly. The problem demands some serious, serious thinking and not just poll-driven. We want demographically inspired messaging. That means race war. And that's come out in the Soros emails. So now you understand. They're sinking. They're imploding. Their only move now is to try to steal the election and start all sorts of civil war, class war in America, a 1917 operation. Now, we are not gonzo journalism. I did not set out to make myself a story. But because we are so effective at InfoWars.com with our amazing crew, working with other patriots like DrudgeReport.com, Breitbart, WorldNet Daily, Daily Caller, and others, we have the president, the vice president, Madam Secretary Clinton, Tim Kaine, ABC, NBC, CBS, all of them. So many videos coming in. I can't even see half of them. I was up late last night watching it come in, this morning analyzing it. We're getting hit by thousands of news articles every few hours. We are being hit by multiple TV attacks every hour. They've even got C-SPAN guests on doing panels attacking us. They are going 100%. They rigged it with the Republicans. They had it, they admit, 15 months ago to leak this on to Trump with his jock talk, where he says the women are throwing themselves on you. You can even grab them. That's not assault when the woman's on you. And it's uncouth. I don't like it. He says he's grown, but it shows that they don't have any history to blackmail him. They've had to dig this up. The point is, Hillary is whole universes worse. Not magnitudes, but it just, it's indescribable. They've got massive WikiLeaks coming out. Now WikiLeaks, and I said this a few days ago, I said, now I see their genius. It's exponential. They go from once a month to once a week to every 3 days to every day. Now they're dropping every day. 1,200 more just hit today. Even more devastating. And again, that's why, I mean, I'm sitting there with my limited crew trying to go through these. It's all just total criminality. Oh, we're going to keep them dumb. We're going to take what they got. We're going to get their guns. We're going to take over the media. We're going to cause civil war using Muslims in Europe, and we'll have Catholics and Orthodox killing each other in Ukraine, and we'll have black against white in the U.S. turn up the rate. You know, I mean, it is incredible. I mean, we have them. You understand? This is not our opinion that they say they're losing in their emails. Hell, in her fundraiser email, she admits that Trump's way ahead. We've got to get Roger Stone on today to get his take on all the things that are unfolding, because it's just amazing. He's been so busy on what he says his other October surprises that I've not got his comment yet on Danny Williams. I know he's aware of the case and covered it over the years, but look at DrudgeReport.com if you're a TV viewer, radio listener, you can go there. CNN orders blackout on Clinton's son. He'll be here in 1 hour. I mean, he's here. He was just in here during a break earlier. There he is standing right there at the television that I'm pointing at. And then, of course, we also tweeted a photo of he and I standing there, just so folks know this is indeed going on. And listen, I interviewed his aunt. I went back and checked the records in 1997, and Danny was a young man then. I mean, he's only 30-something years old now. I need to get his full bio. And he was a little kid then. I remember having her on then, and they were never even wanting money or anything. They just wanted him to recognize his son, who Bill gave $700 to every month and who gave him Christmas presents and stuff, and who tried to climb the fence when he was a little kid, and all the rest of it. I mean, this is an epic story, a Greek tragedy. And I believe Danny. Then you find out the star claimed they did a DNA test and didn't. So whether he's Bill Clinton's son or not, I think he is. He looks just like him. They could have done a real DNA test. When Bill Clinton got asked about this a few weeks ago, that video's coming up, he looked extremely, extremely guilty and did not want to talk. And the campaign started flipping out. So we know Bill Clinton frequented ladies of the night, the oldest profession. I'm not judging him. Got to do what you got to do. And it won't be the first time elitists have had children out of wedlock. But the decent ones take care of their children. Say what you want about Jesse Jackson. He's got four or five. Turned out each of those women was in a nice house being taken care of. I thought people, Democrats that were there in 96, not just on air but off air, and they've confirmed that Jesse Jackson would actually try to protect kids and young women and say, watch out when you got around Bill Clinton. I mean, that even Jesse Jackson, who's got his problems, is better than Bill Clinton. And that's how, again, entitled these people are. And Hillary's even worse. Bill just wants to have sex with you or rape you if he has to. Hillary wants to rape the whole country and the whole world. So Danny Williams coming up. Again, let's put out the tweet because the media says everything is a conspiracy theory. Let's put the real Alex Jones tweet out. We also took a photo of he and I together. If we haven't put that out, please tweet that out as well. Okay, let me get into the latest developments here because they are massive. Trump has come out and said Hillary wants world government, unlimited immigration, ruled by corporations. That's why they're completely panicking. So there it is. We're going to get that video for you. Hillary wants world government, unlimited immigration, ruled by corporations. Isn't that just special? So they can't stand it because she's in the emails wanting world government. World government's now out in the open. The Pope's calling for it. They wanted to deny they were building this thing the whole time. Now it's here. Now they're doing it. Now our credibility's giant. And they want to say we're kooks because we're warning of a private corporate world government and TPP. And that's what's happening. We have new Biden audio sabotaged his presidential aspirations. Biden aide sabotaged his presidential aspirations. Surrogates plan to fool bitching Bernie voters. They sent in people as psychological operators to manipulate them. Clinton staffers discuss which emails to release. New York Times gave Hillary veto power. They now have leaks on Hillary dealing with leaks years ago or hacks on hacks where Hillary was directing the New York Times, okay, we've got leaks, we've got hacks, you've got to report on it, you've got to act like you're journalists, but here's what you're allowed to report on and what you're not. As I always told you, with the leaks, they only show the weak ones. That's what they'll talk about is some little side issue when there is an incredible, over-the-top, mega-massive bombshell information. Now, before we continue any further, let's start getting in to why they're freaking out so bad and why they want to claim it's such a defeat that we have Bill Clinton rape protesters popping up at every national event that Hillary, Kane, Obama, or Clinton, Bill Clinton do. That's because it's devastating. And then we've got, during these same confrontations that happened yesterday, three of them at one event, but all total three separate events that had happened at. So that's six disruptions. They send people to go disrupt Trump rally screaming racist. That's not true. We're here screaming rapist, which is true. You settled rape cases. But first, I want to play Obama responds to Alex Jones' sulfur comment, which I covered earlier in the week. And if you're a new viewer and like he's not responding to you, CNN, the Associated Press, Mother Jones, they're all quite clear. He's responding to the evil radio host Alex Jones. They're just so afraid to ever actually say who we are so people come here and find out what we're saying. They'll say Rush Limbaugh's name. They'll say Sean Hannity's name. They won't say this one because it's so damning. Because I'll cross-reference everything. I'll show you the backgrounds of it. I'm unfiltered. I'm uncontrolled. I'm not on a big network. But I've built something bigger than what they've got. That's what they can't stand. There's not much else out there like that. Drudge. That's why they're trying to shut down the free internet. That's why they're bringing in all these regulations and admitting they want to shut it down. First, they didn't want to shut down free speech. Now they admit it. First, they didn't want to double tax you with Obamacare, now they admit it. First, there weren't death panels, now there is. First, they weren't coming after your guns, now they admit they want to ban them. And that's in the WikiLeaks. But hell, that's in the newspapers. So they're in a lot of trouble because first the NSA wasn't spying on you, now it is. Because it always was. So he makes this joke about me saying he's got flies landing on him, which biblically is associated with the underworld, with Satanism, with corruption. But all I'm saying is it's an archetype. The actions of Obama and Hillary are war and death and corruption and poverty and wanting to make us poor so they can control us. That's an aspect of evil. They don't want prosperity. Let's go to that clip.
They demonize each other. And I mean that literally, by the way. I was reading the other day. There's a guy on the radio who apparently Trump's on his show frequently. He said, me and Hillary are demons. Said we smell like sulfur. Ain't that something? Now, I mean, come on, people.
You know, did you pick up on that? Bill Clinton's so good at that. Yesterday he's like, listen, I can tell you these rednecks are racist. Trump's got bad people that are out to get you. I used to be one, okay? I used to be a red. No, you were a Dixie Mafia, son of the Mafia, brought in to dominate the poor white people, black people, and others of Arkansas. You did such a good job of the CIA, they put you in charge of the whole country. What you are is a predator, Bill Clinton, and you're showing race baiting. That's the latest clip we've got. But Rachel Maddow went crazy last night dealing with all of this and trying to misrepresent what we're saying and what we're doing. So let's go ahead and play this report.
A new phenomenon that you may have noticed at recent Democratic rallies. We first saw it in Las Vegas Thursday night. Tim Kaine was interrupted by a protester who was wearing a shirt that said rape on it. And the guy yelled out, Bill Clinton is a rapist. That first happened Thursday night. Then we saw it happen multiple times at multiple Clinton events today, including one where the featured speaker was President Obama and one where the featured speaker was Bill Clinton himself.
There's a guy on the radio who apparently Trump's on his show frequently. He said, me and Hillary are demons. Said we smell like sulfur. Ain't that something?
There's a guy on the radio. The guy on the radio is Alex Jones, who runs the InfoWars conspiracy theory website and internet radio show. And in fact, he does call President Obama and Hillary Clinton demons. He says they smell like sulfur. He says he has it on good authority that they are, in fact, literally possessed by demons.
He is an abject, psychopathic demon from hell that as soon as she gets into power is going to try to destroy the planet. I'm sure of that. And people around her say she's so dark now and so evil and so possessed that they are having nightmares. They're freaking out. Folks, let me just tell you something. If the media wants to go with this, that's fine. There are dozens of videos and photos of Obama having flies land on him indoors at all times of year, and he'll be next to 100 people and no one has flies on him. Hillary reportedly, I mean, I was told people around her that they think she's demon-possessed, okay? I'm just going to go ahead and say it, okay?
All right. Ready to connect the dots? The guy who says he has it on good authority that President Obama and Hillary Clinton are literally demons, he's the reason we're getting the people screaming rape at all the Clinton events now, because he and his conspiracy theory demon possession website, they are now, in support of the Trump campaign, they are now offering a $1,000 bounty to anyone who can get a Bill Clinton rape shirt on TV for at least 5 seconds. They're offering a $5,000 bounty to anybody who can be heard on TV saying Bill Clinton is a rapist while wearing the shirt. See, it's a way to sell shirts. So these protests breaking out at Democratic rallies, they're not organic, right? They are highly coordinated with a monetary incentive by Donald Trump's number one internet radio conservative internet conspiracy theory supporter, the guy who also says President Obama is a demon because the flies tell him so. So there you have it. Ta-da. Dots connected. Nausea induced. We'll be right back.
Monsieur Maddow, I can tell that you have a certain persuasion in your life by your mannerisms and how you act. Hey, I don't care about that persuasion, but that's what told me not the flies. Now, in the case of that, I was baiting you, just like I baited you about election fraud, to cause a national debate and have Obama deny it exists. I know how you'd operate. And then have you panic and force a public takeover of Homeland Security of elections because I knew it was already planned from my sources. I devastated you. You are a small-time jackass that reads off a teleprompter. I don't. I read off history and deep research in my sources. And believe me, you think you've got that tottering, doddering Hillary as your goddess telling you what to say and what to do. It's in all the WikiLeaks. We have the good people in government. We have the good people in corporations in this country and worldwide that don't want to live under your evil, that are aware of you. I'm just one manifestation of that. Cut me down, two more will grow back. That's how it works. And so you know that. you're doing a big confidence game. This morning they told me, did you see Maddow attack you? And I said, no. But she'll say, we've discovered the secret. He's paying people. It's all fake. Kind of like, we discovered a secret. Oh, he was on Howard Stern. It's secret tapes. No, it was live on the radio with him asking him dirty questions. Trump never hid any of that. That's the whole point. Wow, new Howard Stern stuff. Man, boy, oh, boy. And as soon as I hadn't even watched that until we played it. I said, I want to see it play it. I told the crew what it would be because I know. Oh, we caught him. They're not doing this for ideological reasons. They're doing it for money. Really, a lot of folks have told us they don't want the money. We did it to make it interesting. You know who did want the money? You can Google this. It was the WikiLeaks, you know, back in July, early July, right before the RNC, that Hillary had paid with George Soros and move on to send buses all over the country to Trump events, dressed up like Bernie Sanders to attack Trump supporters and blame Trump and then blame Sanders. You're paying people to go beat people up and scream racist and throw eggs in people's faces and beat them over the head with Mexican flags, putting out lies and then stealing the nomination from Bernie Sanders. We're simply saying he's gone out and he has settled sexual assault cases and other cases. There's a news blackout, just like there's a CNN news blackout. They admit, Drudge has the source, on Danny Williams, who's coming up in 50 minutes. There is a blackout on talking about rape of Bill Clinton, talking about sexual abuse, talking about settling cases, talking about any of the other women. Okay? That's what's going on. And Hillary has completely, absolutely ignored him. We have video of Bill Clinton totally ignoring him. And we're here causing a national debate. We know we have a bigger audience than CNN. We're calling their bluff. We're taking action. We're in their face. And absolutely, people say, man, you got a lot of courage. Absolutely, I do. But it takes greater courage to let these demons, these globalists, take over these monsters, these fascists, these oppressors, these tyrants run our lives. I can't help but resist them. We have seen nothing but failure from the globalist corporate press trying to steal the nomination from Trump, trying to block him, saying he could never be the nominee. Now trying to pull every hoax they can with the same Paul Ryan and others walking out on Trump for the third time. Trump's talked about the fact that he's now talked to the insiders. You got Jerry Falwell Jr. and others have come out and said, no, there was a Republican conspiracy to leak this info and derail this for Hillary. It's not a if three or more people meet, or two or more really, and decide to try to do somebody harm, it is a conspiracy under law, but they said they were still going to get Trump. They said they wanted Hillary over Trump. They said they were going to be part of this the entire time. See, that's what's crazy. Charlie Rose has guests on from the White House saying, we lied to everybody and told them they could keep their doctor, and then they laugh about it. I played the thing like 10 times last week. The week before that, they were on TV making fun of people about something else. The week before that, they do victory laps on C-SPAN and on PBS, where they think it's a more intellectual audience, about how they're conning everyone. I mean, do you understand, folks? These people are literally mentally ill, in my view. Because they think they're the only ones that are smart. And they think everybody that is smart must be a predator like they are. I've had globalists try to hire me so many times. We've talked about it. And they tell you, you're smart like us. Join us. Don't be all the scum. They're so elitist. Now, I've got a bunch of clips I want to play here. When we come back, we've got Obama being interrupted three times yesterday by folks exposing Bill Clinton's rape. We've got new Donald Trump ad that's very powerful, targeting Hillary's health. We've got Mike Huckabee compares Trump to Captain Quint hunting Jaws. And they go, yeah, but Captain Quint died. The point is he got the shark dead too. No, Huckabee knew what he was doing. Great allegory. Quint is brash. He's cusses. He's nasty. But he's the good guy. Just like in Lord of the Rings, not the movie, but the book, they say to Aragorn, they say, well, why didn't you go with those other guys who were going to slit your throat once they got you out of here? And he goes, well, they looked fair but felt foul, while you look foul but feel fair. The best people I've ever known aren't perfect, and I'm not lauding being foul. I'm not lauding being worldly and nasty, but nasty at a base level of just the flesh, like loving women, loving to fight, you know, you know, those are the people, though, that have the heights in their psyche of wanting to build things and loving God and being good. Their good side's so big that they've got a big evil side, but it's still much smaller than the big good side they have. You run into people that are totally controlled and focused and a little twinkly-eyed like Paul Ryan. That's a psychopath. I can take one look at Paul Ryan and tell you that man is a psychopath. He's not a sociopath. He's a psychopath. I'm going to go to break, come back with all of this in the second hour. We haven't even scratched the surface of the new WikiLeaks. This is amazing. WikiLeaks has really come through, so that's good to see that happen. The listeners have come through. You're amazing. God bless you. I've extended it one day, but it's over because people are asking me to. DNA Force will end tonight, 23% off. The new special is on a very inexpensive product we have that is the highest quality. This is really an amazing product. Knockout Sleep Support, 25% off flash sale for only 48 hours only. And it's got, you know, $19.95, that's what the leading competitor costs, just of this amount of melatonin. Then it's got the L-tryptophan and the valerian root and a bunch of other stuff in it. The best sleep ever. This is so amazing. Knockout. InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. Sign up for auto ship, an additional 10% off, and all shipping is free on orders of $50 or more, and your funding is essential. We'll be back. Stay with us.
John Adams, signer of the Declaration of Independence and the second president of the United States, told the military in a speech made in 1798, "Our Constitution was made only for a moral and religious people. It is wholly inadequate to the government of any other." And it was Prussian statesman Otto von Bismarck, shaking his fist at the United States, who said, "There is a providence that protects idiots, drunkards, children, and the United States of America." And that protection was on full display at the second presidential debate. With all of the New World Order's media and all of the New World Order's CIA operatives, they just couldn't put Humpty Dumpty Hillary back together again. Isn't it ironic that the roughly 28 million people watching the second presidential debate witnessed in live time the crushing weight of American providence in action? The symbolism was palatable. Just as Obama had been plagued by flies as his two-faced politics took the reins of power of the nation.
This guy's bothering me here. I'm going to start at I Will Contrast. Hey!
Beelzebub, Lord of the Flies, made yet another appearance, clinging to Hillary's evil glowing radiance.
First, let me start by saying that so much of what he's just said is not right, but he gets to run his campaign any way he chooses. He gets to decide what he wants to talk about.
And in one of the strangest presidential debates in American history, a former president meekly sat on the sidelines, faced with three of the women he raped. Meanwhile, Hillary, in true arrogant aplomb, railed on Donald Trump about a joke he made 11 years ago.
And he has said that the video doesn't represent who he is. But I think it's clear to anyone who heard it that it represents exactly who he is, because we've seen this throughout the campaign. We have seen him insult women. We've seen him rate women on their appearance, ranking them from 1 to 10.
Then providence struck.
You can say any way you want to say it, but Bill Clinton was abusive to women. Hillary Clinton attacked those same women and attacked them viciously. Four of them here tonight. One of the women, who is a wonderful woman, at 12 years old, was raped at 12. Her client, she represented, got him off, and she's seen laughing on two separate occasions, laughing at the girl who was raped. Kathy Shelton, that young woman, is here with us tonight. So don't tell me about words. I apologize for those words. What President Clinton did, he was impeached. He lost his license to practice law. He had to pay an $850,000 fine to one of the women, Paula Jones, who's also here tonight. And I will tell you that when Hillary brings up a point like that, and she talks about words that I said 11 years ago, I think it's disgraceful, and I think she should be ashamed of herself, if you want to know the truth.
Can we please hold the applause?
Bill, Hillary, Obama, the CIA, United Nations, New World Order, The sleeping giant is awake, and it just had you for breakfast.
She got caught in a total lie. Her papers went out to all her friends at the banks, Goldman Sachs, and everybody else. And she said things, WikiLeaks, that just came out. And
her falling down on 9/11
lied.
Was
now
problems.
She's blaming the lie on the late, great Abraham Lincoln. That's one that I haven't. But when you talk about apology, I think the one that you should really be apologizing for and the thing that you should be apologizing for are the 33,000 emails that you deleted and that you acid washed. And then the two boxes of emails and other things last week that were taken from an office and are now missing. So we're going to get a special prosecutor and we're going to look into it, because you know what? People have been, their lives have been destroyed for doing 1/5 of what you've done. And it's a disgrace. And honestly, you ought to be ashamed of
Secretary
yourself.
Secretary Clinton, I want to follow up on that. I'm going to let you talk about email.
Because everything he just said is absolutely false, but I'm not surprised.
Really?
In the first debate,
and we
in
really,
the first debate,
John Bowne for Infowars.com.
I believe Danny Williams' story. I interviewed his aunt. I remember talking about it and covering it. I went back and did some research and found references to it. And I remember his aunt, the church lady, hardworking lady that raised him back when he was like, I think, 10 years old at the time. And because the media is spinning this, oh, there's some guy from Arkansas claiming he's Bill Clinton's little bunch of kid. Here's a dirty trick. Dirty trick? They spent him trying to climb the fence when he was a little kid to see his daddy. Clinton didn't do a DNA test like he said he did. That was all fake. We looked into it. It was a tabloid owned by the Clintons' friends. That's all coming up. But this is just about how evil these people are and how fake they are. That's why we're covering this today. So Infowars.com exclusive, Danny Williams, the reported son of Bill Clinton, in studio. And we've not really done any pre-preparation either. I know he sent me Facebook and Twitter deals over the years. He's talked to Biggs. He likes Biggs a lot. They've talked. And this was going to be in a couple other big publications. But at the end of the day, Danny said, yeah, I just want Alex Jones to put this out. I didn't even ask for it. It's crazy. I didn't even ask to have the exclusive. And we just got it because I guess Danny's followed the show some over the years. So that's what this comes down to, is everything the Clintons tell you is a lie. And we've got big news articles out in the Daily Mail. Are these the Clintons' secret grandkids? Their father, the man who claims he's Bill Clinton's love child, says his prostitute mother slept with the former Arkansas governor 13 times and received $700 bills every month delivered by a state trooper. I remember that back in the 90s covering it. And all I know is I got beat up in a parking lot saying shut up about the Clintons, and then lost my job after I had people on about it. I never knew exactly what it was with the Clintons. They wouldn't say. They just said, stop talking about the Clintons. I kept getting death threats on my cell phone, death threats at my office phone. One day I'm on the office phone. We're going to kill you outside. You don't show up at the Clintons. I'm like, oh, go to hell. I walk outside. They walk around my car, and they go, we told you. Boom, broke my nose. I was like, oh, wow, you really mean business. Of course, old crocodile brain shifted into gear, and I'm not the toughest guy around, but four guys attacking in a parking lot, I beat the living hell out of them. They were barely getting in their Astro van when I was done with them. But that's the side. I'm not trying to act tough. I'm not tough unless four guys are trying to kill me in a parking lot. I beat the living hell out of them. But this is the type of stuff I've dealt with in my life. I mean, I got hit too, but it shouldn't even hurt me. It was like, blood spurting out there, big deal. I'm about to tear your face off. All right, I'm flashing back to it. I apologize. I'm not into violence, but when somebody attacks you and breaks your nose and you punch them and their nose rips off their face, I mean, the cartilage came out, nose is like hanging. It's just like victory. They hit the ground, boom, it's like, I'm standing, blood spraying, let's go. Just like we do in the info war, ladies and gentlemen. We're not bragging. It's no brag if it's fact. All right, excuse me. See, I got to get hyped up to do this, though. This isn't fun. When I see some new video of Hillary confronted by Bill Clinton's a rapist, it's all over the news, and the president attacks me yesterday, you know, I'm doing my duty. And it's scary, it's dangerous, and so my animal instinct kicks in and starts liking it, just because I guess that's the comforter for doing this type of stuff. But so I apologize for being such an animal. But that's the stuff that gets me through. That's why God made me to be a crazy animal. I mean, I've got intellectual tools, some of the best. But I am, at the end of the day, a crazy caveman. And I feel good putting Danny Williams on the air. I feel good exposing these people. I feel good standing up for the Christians, the 200,000 plus murdered in Syria alone. And the country was 20% Christian. And Obama gets up. I want to find that clip where he goes, people say we got to let Christians in. No. We're going to be fair. We let everybody in. He laughs because he knows there's an embargo. They let 0.4 Christians in. For every couple thousand jihadis, they let 0.4 in. Think about that. Same thing in Europe. They're not letting the Christians out. They're murdering them. And you ask, why are they out to kill Christians? Because Hillary Clinton and Obama are public, and they're also in their emails, hating Christians, hating America, hating Jesus Christ. Because America, for all its evils and all its problems, was a Christian nation, was given providence by true Christians that even predated the official church, who were always there. And they believed they were going to build a new continent. Now, the globalists have put out a bunch of false prophecies and false info saying America won't even exist during the Great Tribulation. So you don't understand, America will be the decider of what happens in the Great Tribulation. They tell you it doesn't exist in Scripture because globalists have infiltrated the church. And they don't want you to know America will decide the future fate because God gives us free will. But I'm not going to get into all that right now, ladies and gentlemen. The point you need to understand is Bill Clinton and Hillary don't like being called demons. And I figured it out. They're all competing to be the Antichrist. And that's an insult. That's like calling them a dishwasher. So let me call you this. Antichrist spirits. Does that make you happier? You are aspiring to the Antichrist world government. You are openly establishing world government that's anti-human, anti-prosperity, that's genetically engineering and mutating all major species. You are the very archetype of the Bible's warning of he that comes to kill, steal, and destroy, and overthrow God's creation. So I apologize for calling you demons. You are aspiring, empty souls begging for Satan to enter you. If that's better, I apologize. You've been given your full title. Satan has a large closet with a lot of clothes hanging, a lot of empty souls, a lot of empty vessels. And you're all there clamoring to be fitted with his spirit. You're all there like Avatar, wanting him to jump into your body. And so I get why it made you so mad. I apologize. That's right. You're not demons. You wouldn't be controlled by a demon. You are aspiring to the Lucifer spirit. I got involved in your religion. I understand. What do I know? I apologize to you profusely, obviously. That's why you get so upset about it. Because believe me, it's not because it's discrediting we're talking about it. They want to go, don't go there. Don't go there. Oh, that discredits them. Oh, boy, Trump, don't go there. Because you know it will destroy you. You know we carry the intelligence that will take you down. You know it. You hate it. You can't stand against it. As long as those of us that know the truth are willing to do anything legal and lawful to stand against you, as long as we set ourselves against you, set our wills against you, set our spirits against you, it's a spiritual war, folks. God will then back us up, but we have to go through the tribulation. And believe me, it is intense. But every day you wake up and you're only stronger after it. But the trial of fire, I know why a lot of people don't want to be spiritual and love God, because when you love God, the enemy comes against you. And the trials are substantive. But for me, the trials are like coming up for air out of the ocean. It's the struggle of birth. And it's the birth of the fall of Satan. The final fall. All right, I've already waxed poetic here today. I'm going to skip this network break because of the epic nature of the transmission we are engaged in here today. The WikiLeaks are out there. It's more of the same. Running the media, colluding, engaged in crime, selling U.S. secrets. One of these is like life in prison. Just total, absolute criminal activity. America's being shown the total evil of our government. It's been hijacked by criminals before we're judged. And you cannot believe in God. The point is, humans through group movements manifest a style, a spirit. You've got classical architecture, you've got Victorian architecture, you've got classical American architecture, you've got cubism, you've got all this stuff. You know, it's the spirit of our age, and you have to decide which spirit you're with. And that's why I get into spiritualism, because they're so scared, because that's what they're obsessed with. It comes out in the news. The Clintons, Obama, all of them, Francois Mitterrand, Tony Blair, the current British Prime Minister, they're all completely obsessed with the occult. It's Skull and Bones, Bohemian Grove. And they laugh. Oh, Alex Jones is calling us out as the devil. Says we're under plagues. Says we're under flies. Oh, God. Boy, keep doing that. You're going to make us win, Alex. Whatever you do, though, throw me in that briar patch. Now, I got a lot of the clips here I want to play. Briefly, let me just fund this operation right now. You know, I'm just going to tell you, there are some good nutraceutical companies, supplement companies out there. And the ones that are good, we promote. Like Youngevity has 500 products now. I can't speak for them all, but they have a very high standard. I know over 100 of their products that I've vetted and used and sell are amazing. Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst Plus, all, I mean, they're excellent. That's InfoWarsTeam.com. You can buy them there. Get a discount when you sign up as a distributor. Get free shipping when you sign up for AutoShip. If you want to support the broadcasting Youngevity products, it's InfoWarsTeam.com. And there's a toll-free number there to order via the phone as well. But I've developed with top scientists, top firms, top companies. A lot of these top organic producers in the world, they go, we'll work with you, we love you, but we don't want to be targeted, so don't say where you get this stuff made or where it gets manufactured. Dr. Group makes about 45% of our products. The others are made by the other two big organic top-rated companies. Because I know I'm a political target, plus I want to sell high-quality stuff to have you buy it again at a low price. It's just free market. But the average supplement company has 5 to 7 times markup. Let's say there's $5 counting the cost of the bottle and the product. They sell it for $30, $40. If we're selling something for $100, there's like $50 in product in it. If we're selling something for $19.95, there's $10 of product in it. And people go, why don't you sell a bottle of melatonin for $19.95? That's the industry standard. Just have a prettier bottle and better marketing. Then I go, but I want L-tryptophan. I want valerian root. I want the organic melatonin and 7 other ingredients, and I want to sell it for the same price as just a bottle of melatonin of the same dose. And then I'm going to come up with my own name for it, Knockout. Because when I get all fired up and I'm going on too many cylinders, and my problem isn't too few cylinders, my cylinders just keep on going. I can't actually handle it. I take this and, you know, 1, helps you sleep good. 2, knocks your butt out. Takes about an hour, knock your ass out. And it's got it all. The hops flower, the lemon balm, it's got it all. And it's got it all in good dosages, and it's organic, and it's a game changer. So it's a great deal at $19.95. Well, guess what? It's 25% off right now. It's $15. And that $5 we make on this helps fund our operation. The Hillary for President shirts are almost out of stock, and we're not going to make any more, even though it's viral and out there and helps fund the operation. You want to get that final edition of it, it's there. We have a limited edition shirt made in America. The Gadsden Snake taking Hillary to the mat. Defeating her lies, and that's the lock her up, don't tread on me shirt. InfoWarsStore.com is the umbrella site. InfoWarsLife.com is a sub area, and you can also call 888-253-3139. Ask any questions. I'm at 23% off on DNA Force that will end today. I've extended it one day, and I'll be quite frank, a lot of times it's because I forget to take it down off the website today. I just thought, hey, they tend to love it when we extend it one day. For some reason, we get more funds then. That's what makes you buy it. Fine, I need money for all this operation and what we deal with. I mean, can you imagine what it's like? I'm not the type of bitch you're complaining. Quite frankly, I enjoy the enemy attacking me. It's not sadomasochistic, or masochistic, I guess is a word. It's that just, I know you're trying to stop me. I know I'm right. If I'm out of energy at 10 o'clock at night, I've been working 20-something hours, and I see some crime the globalist committed, it's like all of a sudden I just stand up and I've got 5 more hours of energy. And the point is, we need the funds, we need the prayers, we need to have, I want to hire 4 or 5 more reporters and writers and a few more editors and crew members, because we're overstressed right now. And I'm not complaining, but We've been working 18 hours a day, at least 5-6 days a week in the last couple months, and we'd do a better job if we had a second string. There really isn't a second string here. I got a bunch of stars that love freedom and are fighting hard, that are good people, that bleed red blood. I don't want to say every race, color, and creed, because we're all just, you know, red-blooded. We're not blue-blooded globalists. A bunch of cold-blooded bastards. And we want freedom. We're dedicated, and we're having an effect. And we're interfacing with you. Just breaking down the basic facts. I want to salute you and thank you for your support. But obviously, flying all these guests in and doing all this and covering all this information is expensive. Now, I know I've confused the crew. I said, get ready the clips of Trump. But first, let's play CNN panelist. Bill Clinton rape allegations are effing ridiculous, dude. This is CNN panelist, documented history of sexual abuse against. So CNN panelist dismissed Bill Clinton's documented history of sexual abuse against women as effing ridiculous, dude. Because they've been ordered to do this and act all angry by the head of it. On broadcast of Aaron Burnett, as the networks continue to cover for the Clintons while devouring vast swaths of airtime to Trump locker room banter. Now, they want to say he's this big rapist, tried to rape a woman by saying women jump on you, they let you grab them, to rape when Bill Clinton settled rape. The comments were made by liberal CNN commentator Angela Ray, who went absolutely crazy. There's the other CNN reporter yelling the word pussycat without the cat on the end over and over and over again. They're meant to have this fake outburst because the head of CNN, Drudge has this exclusive, has ordered Danny Williams not to be covered. And I've talked to the reporters who've been told, you don't mention her health, you don't mention Bill Clinton and sexual assault stuff, and now it's you don't mention Danny Williams. That's Jeff Zucker. Well, listen, Jeff, I know you and Clinton and Obama and everybody are working as hard as you can right now and doing everything you can like gangbusters right now to try to shut down the new alt media that you want to call right wing so the left gets into ending free speech. No, they want to end free speech worldwide of everybody. It's not working. Buddy, your average show has 100,000 viewers. Your biggest one's a million. Bro, I've got reporters that get 20 million views a week on their YouTubes. And that isn't like every once in a while. The average is like, for Watson, about 10 mil a week. I mean, what you going to do when we come for you, bad boys? But they're still arrogant. They're showing their ivory towers. They still have secretaries kissing their asses. Except the secretary's going to get us the intel out of the trash can and mail it to us. See? It's happening. It's going down. So let's play her flip it out. Here it is.
I'm sorry. The fact of the matter is, Bill Clinton is not running for president of these United States. I'm not going to let you all continue to say that she allowed him. How did she facilitate it? Because it's not that. That's rape culture, Kelly. You're blaming someone who succumbed to
like
it.
Muslims,
someone committed adultery on her.
She was accused. She was accused of facilitating it last night, and she was deathly silent.
And you're wrong.
She did not deny it.
But you know why? Because it's effing ridiculous. It's so ridiculous. That's crazy.
All you have to do is play the video.
I can't believe y'all. Meanwhile, Robert Stone is paying $2,500 of another victim, and that's what you all are going to be proud of.
Let me bring in Paris and Margaret.
Bought off victims? Give me a break.
Margaret, look, I mean, selective memory and choosing what you, I mean, there are depositions also against Donald Trump that accuse him of rape. Let's be very clear.
And that case was dismissed.
Regardless of whether it was dismissed, they're under oath and they're there, Kaylee, so let's not be totally selective. Let's also just talk about the role of women here, because you know what? Those women were great and they were fans of Donald Trump. They were also at a Donald Trump rally. Right. This is no longer about women that are at Donald Trump's rallies. This is about independent women, Republican women. Yeah. Guess what? 70% of Republican women back in August were going to vote for Donald Trump, to Mitt Romney's 93% of Republican women and John McCain's 89% of Republican women. That was August. That was not now. These numbers are bleeding for Donald Trump. And so it doesn't matter what his fans say. It matters about these women in these swing states and where they're going,
so,
and they're not going.
So that's all a bunch of hype. Trump's losing. Trump's over. It's over for Trump. It's over for Trump. Over and over again, this is how they push this narrative, freak out, but CNN is a husk of itself trying to sell a con that Obamacare's free, you can keep your doctor, God, thank God they're so stupid, over and over again. Speaking of who needs some Obamacare, here's Hillary and the new Trump ad that devastates her that I hope everybody gets at InfoWars.com and shares.
Our next president faces daunting challenges in a dangerous world. Iran promoting terrorism. North Korea threatening. ISIS on the rise. Libya and North Africa in chaos. Hillary Clinton failed every single time as Secretary of State. Now she wants to be president. Hillary Clinton doesn't have the fortitude, strength, or stamina to lead in our world. She failed as Secretary of State. Don't let her fail us again.
Now, I want to correct the Trump campaign, and obviously they know this, but they wanted to make the Middle East a failed state in North Africa. They wanted to topple it to come out Libya. Because Libya was stabilizing all of Africa and actually helping people. But that's why she did that. Hey, Danny Williams, Bill Clinton's son, reportedly, coming in studio here exclusively live when we come back.
While the media distracted you with an 11-year-old tape of Donald Trump's locker room banter, WikiLeaks dropped bombshell after bombshell, and the Clinton mouthpiece media have barely even reported on it. In one email sent by Hillary surrogate Bill Ivey to Clinton campaign manager John Podesta, Ivey brags about how the left has sought to maintain political power by producing, quote, an unaware and compliant citizenry. This is beyond arrogant elitism. It sounds like something out of They Live.
The gains have been substantial, both for ourselves and for you, the human power elite.
We've all been quite content to demean government, drop civics, and in general, conspire to produce an unaware and compliant citizenry. Conspire to produce an uninformed mass who will just do as they're told. The unawareness remains strong, but compliance is obviously fading rapidly. This problem demands some serious, serious thinking, and not just poll-driven, demographically inspired messaging. To emphasize, Ivy admits that the left has conspired to produce an unaware and compliant citizenry, but that they're not as easy to manipulate anymore, and that this is a problem. He characterizes unawareness amongst the public as a positive thing for the Clinton campaign. So we're supposed to be outraged about Trump's locker room banter from 2005. Yet here we have a Clinton surrogate calling the entire population of America dumb and conspiring with the Clinton campaign to keep it that way. And there's no outrage whatsoever. There's not even any media coverage of it. Absolutely nothing. But are you really surprised, given what the other WikiLeaks emails reveal about the level of collusion between the cooked media and Team Hillary? They talk about their friendlies in the media who will blithely regurgitate their talking points. Reporters like CNBC's John Harwood emailing the Clinton campaign, begging to be patted on the head like an obedient dog for lavishing praise on Hillary. The New York Times asking the Clinton campaign for permission to use quotes from their own interview with Hillary. The Boston Globe colluding with her campaign to give her, quote, a big present. This level of cronyism and corruption is staggering, but it explains why much of the media refuses to even cover the WikiLeaks releases. Things like Hillary openly admitting that our so-called allies, Qatar and Saudi Arabia, are funding and supporting ISIS. Oh, but Trump said the word posse in 2005, so I guess that's more important. Confirmation that Hillary deliberately and criminally deleted certain emails to hide evidence of her wrongdoing. Moles inside Bernie Sanders' campaign who betrayed his strategy to tip off Hillary. Bill Clinton's behavior pushing a female Clinton Foundation staffer to near suicide. Insiders within Hillary's campaign petrified about the damage posed by Bill Clinton's sexual predatory past. Oh, but you didn't hear about any of this on CNN. But you did hear Donald Trump say the word pussy in 2005, and to the media, that's what matters. And they wonder why their readership is collapsing. They wonder why 94% of the American people no longer trust a thing they say.
I mean, she is an abject, psychopathic demon from hell that as soon as she gets into power is going to try to destroy the planet.
She's worked like a demon, as you know, as Secretary of State. And
we came, we saw, he died.
What difference at this point does it make?
And there's only one candidate in this race who understands that democracy in a big, diverse country doesn't work if you constantly demonize each other. Demonize each other.
You could put half of Trump supporters into what I call the basket of deplorables.
And I mean that literally, by the way. I was reading the other day. There's a guy on the radio who apparently Trump's on his show frequently. He said, me and Hillary are demons.
I'm telling you. She is a demon. This is biblical. She's going to launch a nuclear war.
Said we smell like sulfur. Ain't that something? Now, I mean, come on, people.
You can't wash that evil off, man. I'm not kidding. People say, they say, that, folks, I've been told this by high-up folks. They say, listen, Obama and Hillary both smell like sulfur. I never said this because the media go crazy with it, but I've talked to people that are in protective details. I mean, they're scared of it. And they say, listen, she's a freaking demon and she stinks, and so does Obama. And I go, like what? Sulfur. They smell like hell.
On November 8th, the arrogance of Washington, D.C. will come face to face with the righteous verdict of the American voter. It's about time.
So much of what he's just said is not right, but he gets to run his campaign any way he chooses.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us. Danny Williams, now of Hot Springs, Arkansas, grew up in Little Rock there at the Capitol, where his mother reportedly met the governor, Bill Clinton, is here with us. I remember interviewing your aunt back in the late 1990s, a church lady, many years, hard worker, great record. You yourself got three children, no record, hardworking guy. I think your story is very, very incredible. We're going to walk through it and talk about it today, but thanks for coming to Austin, Texas, sir. Nice to have him here. We'll turn his mic on for folks. Danny, where to begin here? I mean, let's talk about you personally, where you're right. from, where you grew up, and then we'll start talking about the first time you ever heard from your mother that a certain person was your father.
Right. My name is Danny Williams. I'm from Little Rock, Arkansas. I'm at age 30 right now. And all my life I've been told that Bill Clinton was my father by my mom, my aunt, and other relatives that grew up with me.
I mean, continue. I mean, I know you haven't been on TV before. You're live right now. Please keep going.
yes, I want to know the truth about Bill Clinton being my father. And that's all I ask is the truth.
Do you think Bill Clinton's your father?
Yes, sir.
You know, instead of just going through your whole history, and we're going to do it and mm-hmm. talk about it, play clips of Clinton being asked about you by the press, and he won't respond. We're teleprompter free here. I just, out of the gates, Bill Clinton will be watching this. This is undoubted. Right. You know, Obama responded to us yesterday, Hillary a few weeks ago. They right. watch every day. This is the show's in thousands of newspapers a day, all over every cable channel.
Yes, sir.
We didn't do some pre-interview here. You just flew in at like 11 o'clock today. You just got here about an hour ago.
Right.
Looking at that camera right there, sir, camera four. Bill Clinton, William Jeffrey Clinton will either be watching this live or he'll watch it later. What do you want to say to Bill Clinton? Camera four.
I mean, I'd just like to ask and say to Bill Clinton that I want to meet you. I want to shake your hand. I want my kids to know their grandfathers. And I like to just, you know, I like to just meet them, get to know them, you know. And I mean, I never had a father in my life, so, you know, it's hard. It's difficult in explaining it, you know.
It's okay. Go with it. It's all right. Right. I've talked to you in private. I understand coming from the middle of Arkansas to now being with the top link on Drudge, and you see yourself right there and sitting in all over the world. But just tell it like it is. You believe Bill Clinton's your father. Your mother always told you that. He sent you money, all the rest of it.
Right.
He won't respond to it. So Bill Clinton and Hillary are watching right now.
Right.
Talk about an epic story. The video's on your Facebook. It's on InfoWars. Trying right. to go over the fence at the governor's mansion. You wanted to meet your daddy. I mean, you're meeting him right now digitally.
Right.
Right there, my friend. What do you want to say?
I like to say My name is Danny Williams. I like to just say, you know, I want to be able to experience that having a father in your life, you know what I'm saying? And now I got kids of my own. I want my kids to know their grandfather. They ask me all the time, who's your dad, you know? So, I mean, it's my chance now and get my story out and letting the world know who I am and who's my father and, you know, the truth about everything.
Well, the Daily Mail has the headline, Bill Clinton's grandkids, you know, will he look into meeting with them? We'll go back to that in a moment, but just starting at the beginning.
Okay.
Break down how you grew up in Little Rock, Arkansas. You're now in Hot Springs. What it was like and when you first began to hear this.
Okay. Well, growing up in Arkansas, it was like everybody knew. Everybody, you know, they'd say, that's Bill Clinton's son. And everywhere I go, you know. So, I mean, growing up, it was rough growing up. I mean, we barely was making it. We was broke. I mean, my aunt, she worked two jobs trying to raise us, me and my little brothers and sisters. I mean, everybody in Arkansas at the time I was coming up knew about me being his son, preachers and all. So I just want to be able to just, you know, have the chance and get myself out and explaining who I am and why am I facing the world today to reach my father.
I noticed in the video interview we did that we aired, you talked about wanting to meet him because you heard he was sick, in your own words.
Right. I heard he has Perkins, if I'm not mistaken, heart problems, and they, you know, people ain't living long these days, so ain't no telling when he may pass, you know. So now it's, now it's my chance to be able to get my story out and get it heard to meet my father before that happened, you know, before he, something tragic happened to him.
Well, we can go to Joel Gilbert's website or WorldNet Daily and show some of the articles while you're speaking.
Right.
You next to Bill Clinton for TV viewers watching, I mean, how much you look like him. But I remember back at the time that when I first had your aunt on, it's got to be 20 years ago almost, mm-hmm. 19 years ago, that this is what I was getting from the state police and others. So let's get into what you talk about in the video. When you first start hearing this, before you heard about it, your mother tried to get you in the scene with the governor's mansion. Then right. Later you try to get on the property when you're older. Let's go through this, Danny.
Okay, well, it was my aunt, actually. My mom had lost custody of us. My aunt had
got custody. Sure, your aunt. Right?
Yeah, right. My aunt had got custody of her, my aunt Lucia. So one day she was like, I want, you know, she took me down to the governor's mansion. And she was like, you know, we're going to let him know that you're his son. So we went down there, and she had to sneak through the gates. And she went up to the door, and the butler answered the door. And she asked for Hillary. And the door was slammed in her face, and we was told to get off the property. So she took off running, snatching me by one arm. And all I can remember was my arm hurting, and she snatched me to jump over the fence. And she asked me all the time, do you remember me taking to the governor's mansion? I said, yeah, I remember. I remember you snatching my arm and taking off running. So, you know, I mean, it's never went away. I mean, he have delivered Christmas gifts to my home by Arkansas State Troopers. He have paid my mom under the table. Up until the time he made president in 1993, he stopped doing anything for us. So I believe in my heart that he tried to be in my life.
Well, this is a narrative that comes out from everybody, that Hillary runs the show. Hillary's the boss.
Right.
She actually manages him and uses his issues as a control mechanism. From your research, who is it that kept you away from the man you believe to be your father?
Correct. I think Hillary is the one that kept me away. I mean, as a married couple, your decisions are one. So I'm sure she know of me, and I'm sure she had parts in with the all the publicity, all the stories in the press that, you know, falsely reports all we have taken the DNA, all of that is false, you know. So, you know, I really do think she has played a part in, and as they call, banishing me, you know.
Now, I know it's hard for you to talk about, but,
right.
but you've discussed mentally, psychologically, what this has done to you. I mean, go over the years when you first started. How old were you when you first started learning about this? And then what did it do over the years?
Okay, when I first started learning, I was probably about 8 or 9. I was in school, and, you know, my teachers, they would look at me, and they were like, they'd be whispering, you know, it's Bill Clinton's son. His mother, the one that claims she had the baby by Bill Clinton. And, you know, it's just difficult, you know, growing up, house to house, you know, not stable. It became difficult my whole life. So, you know, I just thought about it, you know, I'm like, it's something true to it that after all these years, they still put out false reports, 1999, 2000, the false DNA, you know, all these articles that they put out that's false about me. But the article that my mother gave in 93, it's, you know, somebody bought rightful ownership to it. And, you know, it make you think. So 2 years and a half ago, I started my Facebook page campaigning for me and Bill Clinton being my father. I wanted to know, and I've always wanted to know. I just never got any help. I reached out to lawyers and investigators. They would not look into my case, no one. So I started campaigning my own Facebook page and saying Bill Clinton, my father, and I'm trying to get my story out.
Well, keep rolling. I love the fact now that you're relaxed. I can tell, you know, you're nervous. Who wouldn't be?
Right.
The head of CNN, Jeff Zucker, and it's all come out in WikiLeaks, too. They order him. Don't talk about Bill Clinton's sex crimes.
Right.
Don't talk about Hillary's health. Don't talk about illegitimate children. Don't talk about it. He, quote, thinks it's a ridiculous hoax. Even though we went and looked at the Star, they never did the DNA test.
Yes, sir.
They did a, quote, test that wasn't even a DNA test. So
correct.
That's how they do it. That's how they get away with it.
Correct.
And cover it. But, I mean, regardless, Bill Clinton's known for all of this. What do you just think about the general sense of what's happening in the country today?
I mean, I think a lot about it. Actually, I think, you know, as far as she stand up and saying, well, the kid, you know, kids going to be, we're going to make sure kids have the rightful, you know, taking care of them and rightful schools, you know, and all this. I actually think that they are lies. And I think she's just using it to be in office.
And to be clear today, when I went there about an hour before he went on air, I said, listen, we've never really talked. We've talked over the phone a couple times. My
right.
crew has. You just flew in today. You've been
yes,
talking
sir.
To Biggs and stuff. I said, will you just please write notes on the questions you want me to ask? And you wrote
right.
this up. These are your thoughts.
Yes, sir.
You've got, these are your questions. One thing that got brought up is Bill Clinton a couple weeks ago got asked about his son, reported son, Danny Williams, by a YouTuber called Charlie in the Box. I want to skip this network break.
Right.
This is so important. I want to play this since you mentioned this and just, again, go back to if you were really in the room with Bill Clinton, because you are in the room with him. He
yes,
will
sir.
Watch this, undoubtedly.
Yes, sir.
I mean, you know, spill it out there because you need to talk directly to him. Because I've talked to the Arkansas State Police back when I was being given these tips.
Mm-hmm.
Believe me, they didn't send people down here to get me fired and get my ass beaten.
Right.
Because you weren't his, weren't his illegitimate son. They're concerned about this. I want to talk about your memories with Mama. And the money and the presence, and which humanizes Bill.
Right.
And we're not just trying to demonize Hillary. She was the one even 20 years ago, before I knew she'd run for president, they were saying was shut this down. So I want to talk about that with Danny Williams, the reported son of Bill Clinton. But let's go ahead and play this clip here of the protester asking Bill Clinton about, well, not even a protester. He's there just at the gate as Obama comes by, you know, shaking hands with the Secret Service, saying, what about Danny Williams? Here it is.
Mr. Clinton, would you like to make a comment to Danny Williams?
Mr. Clinton.
Can you make a comment about Trump saying about rape allegations?
Hey, I don't want to hear any of that. Knock it off.
Can you get any comment about anything like that, please?
Stop. Hey, this is a monumental event for us. We don't want to hear it.
Well, I know, but we got a lot of questions that aren't being answered.
Thank you, President.
From the American people.
I mean, they acted like Danny. They knew what was going on. Bill looked like, have a nice day when he
right.
looks at that camera. I don't want to dehumanize him because I know he's got a lot of problems, but
right.
he did deliver money to you for how many years? And how many?
All the way up until 93, he made presidency. My mom received $700 and $100 bills in her mailbox every month. and the Christmas presents on Christmas, driven by state trooper cars, you know, dropping them off. So I believe in my heart he knows I'm his son, and I know I'm his son because I see it through the features of me, you know, the facial features, the chin, the nose, the ears.
I mean, you do look a lot like
Right,
Brooklyn.
Right. So, you know, I know what my dad looks like.
He looks like me a lot.
Exactly. Exactly. So, I mean, all I want is the truth out. That's all I'm reaching for, the truth. This not no political scandal. I mean, I'm just here for the truth.
I mean, here it is right here. Now, I don't know what's going on. I mean, we flew you in. I'm busy. You're busy. I'm not micromanaging stuff.
Yes, sir.
All of a sudden, I guess during the break, last hour and a half you were here, you did an interview with the crew and they transcribed it. Yes, Bill Clinton's son tells Hillary, step aside. This just went up on Infowars.com. Did you write this before you got here or just today? Because I'll be honest,
I wrote that before I got here, and I'm asking her to step aside. All I want is a sample of his DNA to prove who I am and my story is true today.
We'll put that up on screen. Okay, well, I mean, I'm telling you, folks, he's running the show here today, Danny. And again, why did you choose us to bring this out? Because we...
I choose y'all for one. I need the world to know. And I'm trying to get as many as people I can to let me speak about on the truth of my story and why am I doing this today. I mean, I've been trying all my life to get this out.
That's right. The media spins it like you just popped up now.
Right, no.
I was interviewing your aunt 20 years ago.
No. It's been articles since 93, 99, 98, 95 when he ran for a second term. So, I mean, those articles when I was a kid. And now that I'm grown, they...
And let's be clear. Your mother said he was the only white man she was with.
Right, correct. My mother explains to me all the time. Her story never changed. It's always consistent. The same story.
How did it start? You're 8 years old. What does mama tell you?
My mama told me that she dated him. And, you know, she dated guys for money, you know, to afford to take care of us. So at the time, my mother had two older sons besides me. So she tell me, you know, how he's pick her up. You know, she describes his mother house. You know, everything she describes in 93.
And I've seen photos of your mother when she was young. Very beautiful.
Right. Very beautiful. She's never been always, you know, as people think she is. Oh, she's a drug addict. She's this. She's that. No, she always done what the best she could to take care of
her. She's been down a long road.
Right. And right now she's at this point in her life right now, she's still alive. And she's driven by guilt on how we was brought up and what she could have done better. And, you know, and I feel that she's afraid to speak out public about this situation.
And tell her why. I mean, tell us why. We know what Hillary did. Tell us.
I mean, they try to hush her up. My mom been pushed out a two-story window. She got metal plates in her foot.
By the way, nobody's heard this, but there's been threats. That's why everybody's freaked. Go ahead and tell people what happened.
I get threats today on Facebook. They tell me, oh, they cleansed.
Tell people what happened to your mother. Tell them what the police did. Tell them what the state police did. They're famous for breaking people's arms and legs.
Right.
I mean, Jennifer Flowers.
I was told that she was pushed out a two-story window, and this was told by my mom. She got a metal plate from her bottom of her toes up to her ankle. And I was told that, you know, people was trying to kill her because of her claim of her having a son by Bill Clinton.
Now, bottom line, we're all risking our lives here. So please continue. Talk to Bill. I mean, this is what she gets. I mean, tell him.
Right. And today, Bill, all I want to do is to get the truth out behind who I am and that I am your son. And I would like for my kids, your grandkids, to meet you. I mean, it's more I can say right now. I mean, I'm really emotional.
Ahead.
And
say it. It's all right. I know you broke down crying today before earlier, right. And I know... You've thought about suicide. Tell people, to be honest, here.
I have thought about suicide before because, I mean, you go through this, you know, people don't believe you, you know. You go through this, you're trying to reach your story out, and people are like, oh, he's just a scam. He's this. He's helping Trump. Trump never paid. I don't work for Trump. I work for myself. I done this 2 years ago before she even started running. She supposed to run in 2008 and made president.
I interviewed your aunt 19 years ago. Right. That's nothing to do with Trump.
Right. So, like I say, it's the truth on who I am and where I'm trying to go in my life. I know that with me getting my story out and helping my kids and I raised my kids and I helped raise my little sisters and brothers. I know that one day it is someone out there that might need my help and that'll go through the same thing I done went through in my life. So, no, it's a destiny for me.
No, it makes sense. I know you've talked about this privately, but if he behind the scenes just help out and be with the kids and recognize you, it's like you want to meet your dad. And then you got grandkids. These are grandkids. Like, I mean, let me tell you, if I had a black grandkids, I'd want to know them.
Right, correct.
I mean, I don't care what color they are. I love them.
I had my first child at 16. I dropped out of school in 11th grade, working full-time in a donut shop to raise my child and my little sisters and brothers. So, like I say, it's been hard and rough for me traveling this road, but I never give up and I will not give up until, you know, he step up and say, yes, I'm willing to give you a sample. I'm willing to put this behind us.
So Bill Clinton give the sample and prove it wrong with the third parties watching
it. Right.
He got into it, folks, but his mother got threatened by the state police and Hillary in person to put her in prison or kill her. Then she got thrown out a window a month later. And we've already been threatened over this interview today, just so you know. And when I had his aunt on, I got beat up a week later. You know, all I care about, I'm a very romantic person. Whether I'm 50 when I die or 100, when they stick me in that ground, everybody's proud of me. Everybody knows I stood up for the average person. I wasn't a coward. Danny Williams, I believe your story because I remember, and I wanted to go check on it before I talked about it a few weeks ago, your aunt on the phone, and it was you or some other nurse, and Danny, be quiet, running around, you're like 10 years old, 7 years old, whatever it was, 8 years old, I don't remember, in like late 90s, while she's on the phone just trying to talk about the fact that, you know, her sister had told her this happened and Bill Clinton did this and they were covering it up. And we know about Clinton. We know what he does.
Yes, sir.
And they're so scared of this story. And now Drudge is also linked. InfoWars has it. Bill Clinton's son tells Hillary, step aside. Let's talk about this, but I want to give you the floor. Don't be nervous. Just let it all out. Because in person back there, you're just like me. You're very talkative. Once you get on air, a little bit more reserved. This is your chance to talk to your man you believe is your father, to talk to Hillary, who's just such a selfish, borderline personality disorder psycho. I mean, this is your chance to talk to him.
Right, and I would like to just ask Hillary to please not get in the way of me taking this chance and asking my father for a DNA sample. And
so in the words of Ludacris,
right,
move out the way.
Move. But, you know, it's just been a difficult road, and I'm just ready to, you know, get down to the bottom of it, get down to the truth. I want to know who I am, the my ancestors, the you know, where I come from. I mean, I love my mama and her side of my family. They all black. They all raised me, you know. They tried their best with me. And I turned out a good person. So at the end of the day, it's no lie. It's the truth. And all I want is the truth out. I'm not here for no political gang or nothing. In 1999, 2000, Hillary and President Clinton post, they helped with this false DNA test. And I think it was put out to discredit my story for her running a Senate to the state. So,
and to be clear, we've looked at it.
Right.
The Star, owned by top Clinton donors, did a test that wasn't even a DNA test. So no wonder.
Exactly.
That way they can say the test showed it wasn't. Well, yeah, if they do like a blood test for, you know, hepatitis for maternity, it ain't going to work.
Right. And just,
what would your mother say to you when the Christmas presents came? I mean, did you ever see the state troopers? I mean, describe that.
Right. I was outside playing. I seen them leave. While they didn't pull up in the state trooper police car. I seen them leave. You know, he get out with his police state trooper outfit on, and I see him leave, and I can read the tags, and it say, you know, state government tags on the bag. And as soon as they left, they brought in bags. As soon as they left, my aunt them come get us from outside playing. She was like, come in. And she's like, I got these gifts that was brought in by your dad. I said, brought in by my dad? She's like, yeah. I said, he brought me gifts? She's like, yeah. So me and my little brothers and sisters, we went through the gifts and split them between each other. And it was this one gift that stood out. It was a G.I. Joe man. So I took the G.I. Joe man and I gave the hula hoops and the other gifts to my little sister and them. But it just had me thinking, and, you know, at the time we was kids, so we didn't too much, you know, we went off straight to playing with the toys. But over the years, you know, I just think about that. I just go back into that day of when they dropped the gifts off. I just wonder why, if he feel that he wasn't my daddy, why even assist on wasting the time?
I'll be honest. I don't want to give Bill Clinton a pass, but I've always picked up on this. He's like a twisted, sad character who's used. Hillary's exactly. Pure evil. And you see that. You see the fact that he wanted to do the right thing. Let's talk about the report, how she shut it down, how your aunt tried to get you when you were a baby. Later, when you tried to climb the fence to meet your father. Because this is the stuff that legend's made of. Only reality is this amazing. Danny Williams, straight ahead. Danny Williams is our guest. I just had one of our writers, Merkel Thalen, shown me a personal Drudge tweet talking about all the deception that went on, the people lying to him back when all these, quote, DNA tests came out. We probably put that up on screen and bring that up for Danny Williams. There it is. I was lied to directly by Walter Isaacson at the Time magazine over DNA tests on Danny Williams, Clinton's alleged son. There wasn't one. And that's what we've proven. They did a test that wasn't a DNA test. Now,
right.
You wrote, just in your own thoughts today, questions that were probably good for me to bring up.
Mm-hmm.
But speaking of so many of these, again, I go back to the beginning. Okay. Addressing Bill Clinton. I mean, you've already said a lot, but you say, oh, I'm nervous. I get it. You're on live radio and TV. But specifically, again, you're not political. I mean, you've told me this privately. I'm not for Trump. I'm not getting into Trump. I never even asked that. Did I ask you to go after, support Trump?
I mean, I don't support no one. I'm not voting at the time. I mean,
you just want to meet who you believe your dad.
I just want the truth. I feel like if I'm standing here to prove my story and who I am and the truth behind my story, I feel that he has to stand up and prove that he's not my father if he claims that he's not my father. And, you know, and I like to ask Hillary, please don't get in the way of this. You know, let me know the truth. You know, let it be known. Let the world know. I mean, the world know that you faked the DNA test. The world know that all the others published stories out. So, I mean, it's my turn to ask for the truth.
I was thinking you can do a genetic profile. We know Clinton's basic background.
Right.
And if it matches up with who he claims his backgrounds are, then he's got a lot of pressure on him. Here's a question then. I remember researching this going back 20 years ago.
Yes, sir.
What did Hillary do specifically? I heard she threatened, correct me if I'm wrong, your mother. Walked through that. Who ended the relationship of the state police bringing you $700 a month for your mom, take care of the family, and Christmas presents on Christmas?
Right. And in my heart, I believe Hillary ended all of that once he made president, you know, because it's like he wanted to have something to do with me. I mean, if he took the time out to deliver, have money delivered, have presents delivered, he knew in his heart and he wanted to in his heart. But like I say, I feel that she does have something to do with it. I feel that she, you know, she does breaking that all up. Like, Hillary, she's very smart. So at the time of Bill Clinton becoming to his success, she was planning her success, you know, and being the president for herself one day. So... yeah, I feel that she stepped in and, you know, covered it up, had it hidden, hushed it up. But I never stop. I'm gonna keep this going. I'm gonna search for the truth and you know, if it takes my life, oh well, you know, I'd rather die trying to find the truth of who I am than back home, you know, just doing other things. I'd rather be, you know, dying, you know, knowing the right thing, doing the right thing.
Are you saying you're concerned about your safety?
I mean, yes, it's been plenty of times. My safety, my kids' safety, I'm from Little Rock, Arkansas, and I'm raising my kids in Hot Springs, the boyhood home of Bill Clinton, where he was raised. So, yeah, I feel sometimes about my safety, but I won't stop.
Danny Williams, reported son of Bill Clinton. I've been hearing this for 20 years. The witnesses, we've talked to the state police, you name it. I mean, this was 20 years ago. I was talking to his aunt. This isn't something new. It's coming up now because the Clintons are back again. Looking at this, why would Bill Clinton give you presents and give you money if you weren't his son?
Right. Why would he? You know, I mean, was he playing a little game? You know, to me, I feel that he was trying to be in my life.
Well, it does seem he's the more human of the two.
Right.
Other points. I've got a lot of questions, but other points you think are important?
Other points I think are important. I mean, you can look at me and see, you know, see the futures of him and me. So
we can put those pictures up.
That's a major important point, you know. I started my Facebook page 2.5 years ago, and that's what I did. I put me beside him. I wanted people to know, look at us, you know. And I wanted thoughts and feedback on what people thought, you know. And I take the good and the bad, and I keep pushing with doing what's right myself.
Danny, let's bring this up. And I don't judge your mother. Hell, half the women in the country probably done similar things.
Right.
This is just how the world works. Oldest profession, you know, doing what she has to do is feed her kids. There with the governing class in Little Rock, Arkansas. But looking at this, why do you think Hillary, before I get to that, look at the similar backgrounds. You've got Bill Clinton's mother reportedly being a prostitute to the mafia.
Exactly.
In Hot Springs.
Right. It's
well documented. That is well documented.
Exactly.
Reportedly to a Governor Rockefeller.
Right.
I mean, Al Capone used to run the whole country out of Little Rock,
right,
and Hot Springs. He lived there half the year. For folks that don't know how the mafia worked, that's where the moonshine was made.
Right.
Up until like the 40s. So you've got all this going on, and you've got Bill Clinton's mother, a lady of the night, a prostitute, same history as your mother's.
Exactly.
Maybe that's why he felt guilty, because he never got to see his father.
Exactly. And you know what? I do my research. I done read about all that. I've been reading about this since I was 13, 14. And on his mother, on who his father could be. And, you know, it's just like he had this hard time. Why would he do his own child like that? I mean, yes, my mother was a working lady, but as far as from my understanding is that they dated. He came on several occasions.
That's right, he liked her so much.
Right. He kept coming.
Wouldn't be the first time that happened.
Right, exactly. So I feel that, I know she had to do what she do to take care of us, to bring in food, to bring in clothes for us so we can, you know, be all right for us. But at the same time, I feel that it was more than just money between him and her. So
Danny Williams, a reported son who was basically ignored, thrown out there. Exactly. What's the word you use?
I just banished.
Banished.
They banished me. They said I was raised in Australia. They said I went to the goodest school. No, I was raised in Little Rock. I went to McClellan High School off God Springs in Little Rock. I didn't graduate. I got tons of Facebook friends went to school with me that can confront my story.
That's right, but you did get your GED later, and you have raised children.
I went back to school at 21 and get my GED. I was trying to become a welder and taking care of my kids at the time. You know, I had my first child at 16. I was on the way with my second child at 21. So I wanted to do better for my kids, but I always had this setback on, what about my father? Well, you know, I need to know my father, you know?
How early on did you hear from, like you said, the preachers and the public schools that Bill Clinton was your daddy?
Right. Preachers just come over our house all the time when I was 7, 8 years old. I remember one preacher, and that's preacher McIntosh. He's the one that started the story on Bill Clinton when he was running for president about him having a black son. He called it the black sheep of the family. So, you know, this been going on throughout my whole life. Everybody I run into, oh, he look, you know, they point and they whispering, you know, he look just like him. You know, that's Bill's son. And, you know, sometimes it was saddening. Sometimes it was, you know, it strengthened me because I knew that one day I was able to stand up for what I believe in.
I brought this up 3 times, and you've done a great job. But I just want to give you the floor here. Just Danny Williams, whatever you want to say to the world, the people demonizing you at CNN, the people saying, don't cover your story. If your story was so weak, they'd want to cover it because exactly. They could discredit us.
I'd like to ask CNN to back off. I'd like to ask Hillary with the most up respect and just to please don't stand in the way. I would like to let my father know I does want to meet you one day. I does want to shake your hand. Well, I do want to meet you. I do want to shake your hand. Excuse me. I want my children to know that they have a grandfather, you know? And what type of grandfather he was. He was a good man. He done good when he was president. I mean, but far as with my life, you know, it's just failure. So I just want to, you know, I just want him to know that I am looking forward to meet you. I am looking forward for my kids to know you. I am looking forward for a DNA sample. I mean, I ask you to do the right thing.
If I was worth hundreds of millions of dollars, I'd be taking care of my grandkids.
Right.
I don't care what color they are. And Danny, you come off as very credible. My gut tells me you're Bill Clinton's son. I remember the history 20 years ago. I remember all the cover-ups, all of it. And we sit here looking at this. It's just indicative of the larger lies. I remember talking to the sources that knew your mother, who's still with us today.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, is it accurate that state police came and said, you shut up about this, we're going to figure out how to throw your butt in jail?
100% accurate. My mom's story never changed.
So get into what Hillary reportedly did.
What it was from what I was told at 93, you know, doing all the allegations of me being his son, you know, she was trying to hush her up. You know, they was threatening her. You know, they was passing by the house. They kicked at my grandma's door. The first picture they ever got of me was the baby picture with the Arkansas Razorback shirt on.
They kicked at
my grandma's door and
start over. Sorry, I told him to skip the break. Go ahead.
They took that picture. They kicked at my grandma's door and state troopers did and took that picture off the wall. That was the first picture they ever had. That picture was not sold to the tabloids. Was not, you know, it was taken. So
what'd they do? They took that picture off the wall.
Right. From my granny's.
Describe
house.
That. Take your time. Talk about that.
Well,
because if you're not his son, why are they kicking doors down?
Right. I mean, at the time I was a kid, I can't describe it in what my mom can. But at the time, I know, and she always told me how they got the first picture. They kicked in my granny door and they took the picture off the wall.
Now, what was the point of that?
I don't know. At the time, my mother wasn't giving the story, and the doctor, preacher McIntosh had came out with on the story. So they was trying to get in contact with my mom on stories, and you know, at the time, they was trying to hush
it. I get it. They were getting rid of the picture that proved it.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And so, like I say, my mother, she took a story. She took a DNA. I mean, she took a polygraph test in 93, consist of her story. And she passed it, 100% passed it. And the story never changed today. It's still the same today. You can pick
it up. Do you remember who gave the polygraph?
I was, in 93, I was probably 5 or 6 years
old. No, I understand.
Right.
Yeah.
So
you should probably talk to your mom and your aunt. We need to get them on.
Right.
Because this is powerful information, Danny. But look, she says she hadn't fallen down having convulsions. We catch it on tape. She says she didn't sell us out to the Chinese. It comes out in the WikiLeaks. She says she isn't running the media. It comes out. Obama says he doesn't want our guns. Comes out in the emails. He wants to ban them. I mean, it seems like stuff's turning against them right now.
Right. She says she wants to do the most, get the kids the best opportunities in this world. I'm one kid that they have turned their back on and deserve the best opportunities for my children.
I was about to ask, I mean, because I just want to help all American children, no matter what color they are, but black unemployment's basically doubled under Obama as if you just don't matter.
Right.
And then I see Hillary claiming how Trump's all this big racist and the rest of it. Separate from politics, though, I'd actually see you as an asset if I was them. I don't know why they didn't just admit all this and go with it later after they'd already been president.
Exactly. I mean, if they had any brains that they have in this world, they would have, you know, step up.
Danny, I can sit here and ask you a million questions, but, you know, we talk about, I mean, you wrote this. I want to know what it was like to be in her presence. So I want to.
I wanted to have the opportunities that Chelsea had. I wanted to.
Yeah, because I'm reading this. You wrote this before you came on. I said, hey, give me some questions
all
written.
This was wrote
and these are
by
so,
me. I mean,
sure, these are so personal, though. Yes. I don't even know what they mean because it's your thoughts. It's like, I wanted to know what it was like to be, you know, her parents. So explain these questions you wanted me to ask you. You go ahead.
I mean, basically.
This is from the heart. Right before you went live, I said, write out what it is. And I mean, to be honest, I guess so from your heart, it's like so personal. I don't know what it means.
At the time, okay, I said about last year. At the time, Hillary had a campaign at Philander Smith College, which is a black-owned college in Little Rock, Arkansas. I'd never been in her presence. So at the time, I wanted to know how did it feel to be in her presence. So we went to the campaign, me and a couple of my friends. And I made sure I stood right in front of the podium. which we got clippings of it. And it seemed like she spoke directly at me. I mean, it wasn't directly at me because she had turned and, you know, talked to the crowd, but the things that she spoke about, how it was hard, her mother raising her, how her Chelsea would have the best, you know, and her kids would have the best opportunities, you know, and it just fell directly at me at the time. And I was facing her, you know, and it felt like she knew who I was. She, you know, and, you know, it was hurtful. And then, you know, as I left, you know, I tried to get a picture with her. They hurry up and got her out of there. So, like I said, it was hurtful as I left, because I kept thinking about, like, you know, she know me. She knows about my story. She knows about me being his son.
She's talking about family and being true to her family, and there exactly. You are wanting this connection or to discover. Wow.
Exactly. And so, you know, and it hurt because she talk about her family, her mother, you know. So I'm like, you know.
Well, let's go through some more of these points you wanted to make. Mm-hmm. There's so many. You know, I love the fact, because we didn't script this, knowing my father helped so many people in the world.
Right.
I mean, I could differ with that, but this is how honest right. This all is, these questions. I mean, you're thinking he's this really great guy, and right. You're wondering why this is happening.
I mean, because I take trips to his library. I take my kids to his library. You know, I let them know, you know, this is your grandfather.
Because that's in Little Rock.
Right. And just all the pictures of, you know, him doing so much. He didn't help Haiti. He didn't help, you know, he didn't done so much for the world. And it's just like, you know, what have he done for me? Why haven't he done nothing for me?
No, I don't think he's helping him like he helped Haiti.
Right.
You know, he really did in Haiti. I want to talk about your dad here. This is surreal, folks, because he really wrote these. It's how much he loves his dad. This is our big scripted thing. How scripted we are at InfoWars. I want to cry because I don't even want to say stuff here with this man who I believe is Bill Clinton's son. This is getting too real. I mean, Bill Clinton up there, you know, doing what he's doing, Obama attacking me, Hillary attacking me, and all I know is they're doing all this bad stuff, and these people claim they've got a monopoly on being good, Danny, and I'm going to tell you, Danny, they're not good people.
No, they're not.
And I got to tell you, in between Hillary and Obama and Bill, I'm not saying this to make you feel good, mm-hmm. Hillary is way worse than both of them.
Right. I think so, too, and like she sit up and say, Black Lives Matter. I mean, I want to do my Black Lives Matter. Do it.
Well, let me tell you something. I ever get some beautiful black lady pregnant, I'm going to take care of the kids I have with her. I love kids. I'm not sitting there on some high horse, but how the hell would he take care of his kids?
I love kids. I'm raising mine. I helped raise my little sisters and brothers. Had my first child at 16. I'm still raising my kids. And I went.
Don't you have, like, what do you got, three kids?
I got five kids.
Wow, five kids.
Three girls, two boys. Ages from 3 to 13.
Aren't they entertaining?
Definitely entertaining. They I love all their personalities. I mean, it's amazing. I mean, for me to experience that, and he didn't even get the experience in my life, it's like, it's saddening, because every day of my life, being in my kid's life, I think about why I didn't have this, you know? It just reflects back onto me, to me.
All I got to say is, I just love the fact that an hour before he came on, I said, I'm not going to ask you pre-prepared questions. I said, write what you want to talk about. And a lot of this is how you love your dad and how you think he's done so much good. So why didn't they do it for you?
Right. I think he's amazing. I love to meet a leader of the free world. He was a leader of the free world that done damn good about what he done.
Well, I want to tell the corporate media something. See, I don't do like you. I would have had all this pre-written stuff and pre-planned it. I mean, I got him here saying his dad's great. I mean, we're just covering what he thinks. Everybody in Arkansas knew about people will point at me. That's powerful. Bill Clinton had a man deliver money. We've covered that. I've confirmed that happened.
Right, correct.
Your Aunt Lucille always asks you if I remember the time she took me to the governor's mansion. We've talked about that. I got to tell you, Danny, it's just so real to meet somebody from Arkansas, great folks up there. Now, you say, I want to shake my father's hand. Let's talk about that.
I love to shake his hand. I would love to grab him and hug him one day, you know, and just experience that, you know. It's my father. I want to meet my father. I mean, my little brother, sister's daddy, he took care of us, you know. He did his best he could. He was a mechanic. He taught me how to do mechanic work. You know, but I wanted to meet my own father. I knew that he wasn't my father. Even he never told me, but I knew that he wasn't my father. You see the difference. My little sisters and brothers, they are black. So you see the difference in, you know, and that's with me and my feelings and growing up. I'm like, I know this not. My mom black, my dad black, my little sisters and brothers black. I know this not my real father. You know, I wanted to always know my father. And my mother's story never changed. And with her marrying Danny Williams, my stepfather, she still consists of Bill Clinton being my father. It never changed.
Sure. Let's go back. This is important. The first time, when did she say Bill Clinton's your father?
I mean, I had to been like ages ranging from 5 to 4. You know, this has been going on all my life.
What'd she say?
She said, about five, 6 years, she said, she gets out of jail. She said, man, you looking just like your dad, you know? And she was, I was doing good in school, making good grades. She was like, maybe one day you can be, you know, this good person that, you know, he was, but even though he wasn't there for us, she just thought highly.
She was still looking up to him even though he did that.
I mean, it ain't that we hate.
Well, it's not bad.
It ain't that we hate because we don't practice hate. We try to teach our kids better. So it ain't that we hate. It's that we need to know the truth. And we deserve the truth.
And you deserve to not have your family reject you, Danny.
Exactly.
Well, I know Bill Clinton's scared of this. And Bill Clinton has gone a long way down the dark side. I can tell you that right now. And I just think it's still time for him to reprieve himself. I think Bill Clinton still has somewhat of a soul left. I'll be honest about that. I don't think Hillary has one. And I'm honest about that. No, she doesn't. She's,
right.
She's totally turned over to evil, my friend. We're going to come back and finish up with you with any other comments you want to make. We've got special reports and more we're going to air. But I tell you, this is more powerful than I even thought it would be, Danny Williams. Let's come back. Be sure you give out your Facebook. Notice there's a media blackout on this, a total ban, a censorship. It's a Drudge Report story from his sources. They are not allowed to talk about Danny Williams. We need to make sure his story gets out, listeners. Stay with us. Russians are being told to immediately bring back children from abroad. Russia's done nuclear warfare attack drills with 40 million evacuating major cities. Russia, President Vladimir Putin is canceling diplomatic events in Paris and other things for nuclear war. I'm very calmly announcing that. These stories are on DrudgeReport.com. Infowars.com. Here's Business Insider. Get ready for a severe fall in the stock market, HSBC says. So as gloom and doom as I could ever get, it's now happening. My biggest problem is everything we've warned of is now happening. So our credibility is uber ultra high. I wish this was not the case. It is. Again, we just want to thank Drudge for carrying Danny Williams today. Anybody could probably ask better questions than I did, but it's surreal to be here going through all this. But CNN orders blackout of Clinton's son. Danny's live interview. Hillary ignores him. Those stories are up on DrudgeReport.com. They're also up on Infowars.com. When he leaves us here in about 5 minutes, I'm going to get into the huge Russia developments, the stock market developments, because while we're busy focusing on the Clintons, they're just the little globalist minions that have been put in to kind of be the front people. It's the power behind the throne we should be looking at, which is why I hope Bill Clinton and Hillary rediscover their humanity. And I said, Danny, in closing, and I want to give you the floor so you can just speak from the heart. What else do you want to say? You said, well, I just wish that Hillary would move out of the way. So Danny, you've got 4 or 5 minutes. Then we're going to obviously, after you have lunch, talk to you for the nightly news with any other little tidbits. But you're here. You were told your whole life you're Bill Clinton's son. He gave you presents, all this. They've been putting out fake DNA tests. All this is coming out. What do you want to say to, you were saying Hillary.
Yes. I want to ask Hillary, please don't get in the way of this. And I would like to ask Clinton to please step up and take a DNA and give me a DNA sample so we can put this all to rest. I mean, we know what's true. Just, you know, step up and face it. And I like to ask CNN to back off on me speaking the truth about who I am. I will keep doing what I have to do to get my story out.
Let me ask this question. This is bigger than politics because right. I've been honest with people. If Hillary gets in, unless she shuts down all free speech, which she can right. try, it's a gamble, we're going to get world famous, biggest thing in the world. Exactly. Trump gets in, I'm tied to him. He won't be able to fix everything. I'll get blamed for that. We're going to be hurt by Trump being in. if I was Machiavellian, I'd right. go for Hillary, at least privately. Right. I'm not. I really care about humanity. I do the right thing. I don't care where the chips fall. I just do the right thing. That's how I operate. It's hard enough to tell the truth, much less make crap up. I mean, I'm just going to tell the truth. That's the end of it. Everybody knows it.
Exactly.
But would you, we didn't talk about this privately, but if the Clintons, non-disclosures, whatever, when you got there, met with him, not even monetary, but just admit he's your daddy, hug you, he'll take you on a vacation once a year. I know you, that's what you want. I imagine wanting to know your dad.
It's correct.
So it's not, you told us privately, we didn't talk about it privately, you said, I don't want money, I just want to know he's my dad. I want him to acknowledge me. What is it you're looking for from Bill? You're not just here wanting a paycheck from some guy that gets...
I'm not just here for a paycheck. I'm here for acknowledgement. I want him to acknowledge me on who I am and that I am his son. I mean, I know personally in my heart and believe in my heart that I am his son. I just want him to step up and, you know, step up to the plate.
But like you said, Hillary, he did step up somewhat.
Exactly. I felt he did step up somewhat. Other than that, we wouldn't receive the money we received, the gifts we received. So I felt that he wanted a part in my life. So that's the reason I'm here today to ask Hillary, please do not get in the way. And please, Mr. Clinton, step up to the plate.
I don't want to prompt you. I haven't done that any because I just feel people should say what they believe in.
Right.
But you believe he's your dad. I mean, you want to address him as your dad?
Yes, sir. I'm Danny Williams, the son of Bill Clinton. I'm here today to get the truth out about me and who I am. Yes, I want to address you as my dad. And I want to know the truth. I want to get to the bottom of it and know the truth about you being my father. I want to know all about you, all about your family. Thank you.
So you just want to be recognized by your family.
Right.
Very powerful, Danny. I believe you. And I talked to state troopers and others off record. And I hit a nerve with you, your family on, and a bunch of other things. I don't know what hit the nerve.
Right.
It was Waco. It was you. It was a bunch of stuff. I was going after the Clintons, and they got pissed.
Right.
And they wouldn't do that if it wasn't real. I mean, hell, there's people all the internet claiming I'm married to them, and I raped them, and I'm an Easter bunny, and I'm a devil worshiper, right. And I'm a Vatican assassin, and I work for Israel, and I work for reptiles. It's not true. I'm not a space alien, so I don't care. But let me tell you, they get really upset when you get brought up.
Right. They should. I mean, it'd been nice. I went to bed hungry, balled up, starving, because I had to make sure my baby brother and sister eat and went without eating. You know, they should. I mean.
It's okay. Go ahead and say it. Whatever else you want to add.
I'm trying to keep from crying.
It's okay.
But yeah, they should.
When did you think of the suicide?
I mean, I was in my teens and going through, you know, as far as house to house, clothes not clean, you know, on the streets, just, you know, living the way bums live, you know, and it just was hurtful. And then I just had to pull myself out of that, you know. I've been taking care of me and my kids. I'm not asking for money. I'm asking for a simple acknowledgement in the DNA. That's it.
Well, Bill Clinton can still redeem his humanity, but he has to do it before he dies, and he looks pretty long in the tooth.
Right.
That's another one of the points you wanted me to ask you. Your dad doesn't look too good.
No,
you just want to meet him before he dies?
Right. He does look unhealthy. And I does feel, you know, his time is winding down here. And I does want to meet him. I want my kids to know him. We want to know who our father, I want to know who my father is. They want to know who their grandfather is.
And like your mother told you, she knew he was a daddy because there was one white guy.
One white guy that she had been involved with at that time. I say it was probably 1984, around March of 1984. I go back because I was born in 1985, December the 7th, 1985. So, you know, I go back, I think about, you know, I do a lot of research and, you know, and I ask her, and like I say, her story never changed. It's always been consistent. It's always been the same.
Well, is she proud of what you're doing now?
Yeah, she's very proud. I mean, she's probably somewhere breaking down crying because I'm trying to keep from crying myself. So I know she's very proud. I mean,
well, Danny, I'll tell you, you take a risk doing this, so do I. We're not bragging, but the Clintons are particular, people that back them are particularly evil.
Right.
And so we're here telling like it is, and I believe your story, and I hope you get some justice, and I hope the people out there that are paid corporate minions, you know, aren't too nasty about this, but don't take it bad. Right. You've just come here and told the truth. You put out this report, Bill Clinton's sons tells Hillary, step aside. dealing with all the horrible things she's done. That's up on Infowars.com, DrudgeReport.com. We appreciate the courage of all these affiliates. But bottom line, we're just exploring this. We were proven right about Hillary being sick, proven right about the gun control, proven right about the TPP, NSA spying, proven right on Bill Clinton and Monica Lewinsky, Drudge was. We get it right 99% of the time. And I think if it comes out and there's a third party that do a DNA test, you know, and they say that you're not his son, then then I think you would accept that.
Right.
All right, Danny Williams. Well, thank you. Anything else?
I want to thank you for giving me the chance to speak my story on your show. And I just want to, you know, ask to have my story heard and you know, and get it out there. And him knowing that, you know, I'm trying my best to, you know, I'm trying my best to get it out the best way I can.
Yeah, no, your whole thing's how great the Clintons are.
Right.
I get it.
Thank you.
I get it. You're not attacking them. And we're not here trying to get you to do that.
Right.
Did we try to get you to do that?
I mean, that's not me. That's not in my character.
Yeah, the Clintons were good folks. We'd want them.
Exactly.
We don't want war. We don't want poverty. We want wealth. No. We want success. Get out the way.
I want my kids to have the best success.
Well, I'll be honest with you, Danny. Donald Trump wants that. That's why they hate his guts. Not the Clintons, but the controllers already have the economy and taken over. They don't want competition.
Exactly.
And a free market does that. Now, you've got your Facebook. You've got your Twitter. We can put them on screen.
Correct.
What's the best way for other media that wants to not follow CNN's orders to interview you?
The best way is follow me the way I've been doing. I've been doing Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, anything I could download to put my story out there. The best way is following me. I got Danny Williams, my Facebook. I got my fan page is Danny Williams Clinton. Anything you like to know about me, log on to my Facebook. Inbox me, I'll inbox you back. Thank you.
Absolutely. So you're ready to do interviews now. This is the first live one. Again, thank you so much for giving us the first interview, sir.
I thank you too, Mr. Alex.
You know, whether it was John McAfee or you name it, they say, McAfee goes, I don't know who you are, but everybody says you'll let me talk.
Right.
So, you know, there's not some preconceived, you know, agenda here.
No.
And you got over your points, Al, you know.
Yes, sir.
Bill Clinton's a great guy and everything. So you just want to meet your father.
Exactly. At 30 years, all my life, all I want to ever do is know the truth.
Danny Williams, thank you, my friend.
Thank you.
All right. That's Danny Williams, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to go to a couple clips here. I'm going to walk him back because he hadn't eaten in about 10 hours. I guess he ate something when he got off the plane. But we're going to have him have a little snack. We're going to come back. And then we have who's hosting the fourth hour today? David Knight hosting the fourth hour. I got a bunch of Russia war news and economy news that, quite frankly, has got me shaken. So we're going to begin going over all that. But first, let's play this Trump, where Trump talks about disloyalty in the party with O'Reilly, who's laughing at him, talking about how these guys are total sellouts in this conspiracy. And then the Mike Huckabee compares Trump to Clinton. We're going to play both those back-to-back. Then come back after the break, and I'll get into the Russia situation and the economy. Danny Williams, thank you, my friend. Appreciate your courage. Appreciate everybody else covering this today. We'll be back. Stay with us.
You attacked McCain today as well because he was mad about the tape thing. If you're elected president,
you want to hear McCain?
Well, I know you're going to wail on him.
Let me ask the question. He was desperate to get my endorsement. I gave him the endorsement because he needed it for the primary. And frankly, he ran against a very, very good woman. I feel very badly I gave him the endorsement, but that's okay.
All right, but he isn't getting like my endorsement.
He easily wins his primary. And then all of a sudden, he does the unendorsement
thing.
He's never heard, give me a break. He's never heard salty language before. You know, John McCain, who has probably the dirtiest mouth in the Senate, has never heard, he talked about lewd.
Can I ask the question, please? If you're elected president, you're going to need McCain and you're going to need Ryan. You're going to need these guys.
They'll be there. I would think that Ryan maybe wouldn't be there. Maybe he'll be in a different position. But McCain will be there. They'll all be there.
And you think they're going to all cooperate with you after you're trashing them?
I get along. I know you don't believe this. Well, I get along with you for 20 years, so I guess I can get along with anybody, frankly. Right, but to be honest with you, Bill, I get along with people. I think you know that maybe better than anybody.
I don't know what good it does.
I'll get along with them.
I don't know what good it does to trash people. You can say I disagree. I wish they would endorse me. But to trash them, I don't know what that
good that does.
Because he was begging for my endorsement. His friends are calling.
Be the bigger man.
The first sign of a little bit of difficulty, he unendorses.
All right.
I wouldn't want to be in a foxhole with a lot of these people. That I can tell
you. But McCain's a brave man.
Including Ryan.
While we've talked about the hit Trump's taken in the polls as a result of that tape and so on, I don't know that sort of the mainstream Republican class or, you know, even sort of these elites, if you will, understand how invigorating it was for Trump supporters to see Trump turn to Hillary Clinton and let her have it on some of those issues like emails and trustworthiness and honesty, which we've never seen anybody look right at her and do.
The one thing you have to say about Trump, that he is fearless. This is a guy that is comfortable enough in his views, whether you like them or not, that he's going to take it straight to the other person, to their face. He's not two-faced. He's not a phony. Look, I've said this about him, Megan. He's like Captain Quint in the original movie Jaws. He's vulgar. He's salty. He might even get drunk. He's just a...
He doesn't drink.
Terrible. But hold on here.
Okay.
He's the guy who's going to save your butt and save your family. And so at the end of the day, when he kills the shark, you're happy about it. Now, Hillary is the shark. She's going to eat your boat. She's going to have open borders, immigration out the kazoo. And so the choice is, do you vote for Captain Quint, who's going to save your family, or do you vote for the shark? That's the choice you get to make.
Now we've got Jerry Falwell Jr. As if the conspiracy was secret. They said they were going to get Trump. We're going to sabotage him and want Hillary. The horrible Republicans, the worst of the worst, have resembled themselves, have revealed themselves. We got to get rid of them. Here is the Jerry Falwell Jr. clip.
Well, the whole story just fell in my lap about 6 or 8 weeks ago. I got a phone call from someone who's very close to the top establishment candidates in the Republican Party, people who wanted to be president over the last 4 or 5 years. And he told me, he said, Jerry, something strange is going on. They're meeting regularly, and they tell me that it's a certainty that Donald Trump will not be the nominee on November 8th of the Republican Party. Mm. And I called one of Trump's attorneys. I told him about it, but there were no more details than that, so there was nothing anybody could do. But then when I saw what happened this weekend, and I saw how quickly all the usual suspects jumped on it and started calling for Trump to step down as the nominee.
The suspects, usual suspects? Paul Ryan?
The establishment, yeah. The establishment candidates. He was one that just disinvited Trump almost immediately. Right. It's almost like he knew it was coming.
Are these people who are associated with the RNC, with the leadership on Capitol Hill of either the Senate or the House, how high does it rise?
Very high, but not necessarily the people you just mentioned. I think it's people who were candidates at some point in the last mm-hmm. year or 4 years or 5 years. And so it's very high level.
It's the Bush Global Crime Syndicate that's hooked in with the communist Chinese and the big banks. They're the people put in. They admit they'll never let Trump in, but they failed stealing the nomination. They're failing now. They orchestrated this giant hoax, like, oh, it's over for him. They'll do it again and again. That's what they do because Trump isn't out to get you. Meanwhile, they're so arrogant, they would put a corpse forward to be president like Hillary Clinton. And Donald Trump has a new powerful ad that exposes it. Here it is.
Our next president faces daunting challenges in a dangerous world. Iran promoting terrorism, North Korea threatening, ISIS on the rise, Libya and North Africa in chaos. Hillary Clinton failed every single time as Secretary of State. Now she wants to be president. Hillary Clinton doesn't have the fortitude, strength, or stamina to lead in our world. She failed as Secretary of State. Don't let her fail us again.
Now, we talk about things being surreal. When we come back in the final segment, I'm going to host and David Knight takes over. I have all the Russian news. And it's getting so dangerous, I can't believe it. And then it ties in with mainstream news on the economy. Get ready for a, quote, severe fall in stock market, HSBC. They are engineering this thing big time. The Russians are telling their citizens to come home from abroad right now. That's the final straw. Top story on drudgereport.com. CNN orders blackout on Clinton's son. Let's say Danny Williams isn't his son. I believe he is. Danny believes he is. I've been covering this 20-plus years. Or maybe 20. I was on there about a year before I covered Danny Williams. Danny believes it. He looks like Bill Clinton. I've talked to the state police. This has gone on forever. There was a fake DNA test that never happened. That's been confirmed. And all I know is the Clintons have lied to us about everything. Her health, you name it. CNN orders blackout on Clinton's son, just like they did on health care, just like they did on the health care penalties and Obamacare and gun control and world government. And now here comes Donald Trump, who reads Drudge every day. And he goes and gives a big speech saying Hillary wants world government, unlimited immigration, rule by corporations. That's all true under TPP. Where is the fault with Trump? Emails reveal more collusion between state and Clinton campaign. While she's being investigated, she's running the Justice Department and State Department. Meanwhile, in San Antonio, they're spraying Islam or die things on Christian churches. I mean, this is just getting ridiculous. And then I've got these stories right here. I mean, I read these stories, and I don't even know what to make of them. It's so crazy. Now, I'm going to say something right now. Russia has been in the right because they have less than 3 military bases, like 2.5. They have like 1 coaling station, 2 military bases. They've not been offensive. But Russia's being tricked into offensive action, which will bankrupt Russia. Russia's announcing they're going to start looking at putting troops and missiles in Cuba, which I know our government's done on their border. It's reasonable. And troops in Latin America. That's going to actually, though, make Russia a real threat. And then it's just like, I didn't want a war with Islam, but once they brought him here, I had to have the war. I'm not going to ever side with the globalists against Russia because they're just trying to destroy my own country as well. But Russia should really back off because it's not going to help Russia doing that. But whatever, Russia has a right to fight back. Russia military practicing martial law over nuclear war risk. That's Infowars.com. Associated Press. Putin postpones visit to France amid diplomatic tensions. Russia tells foreign Russians living abroad, that's a story up right now, to get out of those countries and come back to Russia. I mean, this is getting crazy. In fact, I had that article pulled up. I can't see it now. Maybe find it on Drudge. Russia considers opening military bases in Cuba. I mentioned that in Latin America. Putin, we know, destroyed aid convoy in Aleppo, Syria. We're concerned with the deterioration of Russian-American relations, Putin said. Yeah, they know it was our military order to do it. Arms dealer says administration made him safe scapegoat on Libyan operation to protect Clinton. They blamed him for the weapons Clinton got to Al-Qaeda. Pakistan spy agency protecting terrorist journalist claims. But I had that one article I had print on, but I don't have it. That was the most important. I think it was Associated Press as well, where Russians tell foreigners abroad. The other is that Zero Hedge has it. Russian government officials told to immediately bring back children studying abroad. That's the next step to ambassadors being pulled, and then you're not 1 second to midnight. The second hand is ticking into it. So I'm here battling about Danny Williams and, you know, the media and Obama talking about me. I don't care. Just stop starting World War III. And why would they start World War III? To economically cover up what they've done. When you have a world financial collapse, the elites always launch a war. That's globalist, robber baron, British Empire, Rothschild, Rockefeller doctrine. When the stock market goes down, they take you to war. We should get Gerald Celente on the next few days. Red alert. Get ready for a severe fall in the stock market. HSBC says, I'll do 5 more minutes and hand the baton to David Knight. But first, didn't plug all this hour. We need your support. We need you to. You need to get DNA Force, 23% off ends today. You need to get a knockout that's got the melatonin, the L-tryptophan, the valerian root, and like 6 other ingredients, lower price or same prices, the same dose as melatonin in a bottle. $19.95 normally, $14.96 right now, 25% off, and that purchase funds the operation. InfoWarsLive.com, InfoWarsStore.com. Stay with us. We'll be right back with the fourth hour. All right, so the whole world is moving towards war. Stock markets are melting down. As we told you about 7 months ago, Deutsche Bank is going to go bigger belly up than Lehman Brothers in 2007. Business Insider reports, red alert, get ready for a severe fall. That's a quote in the stock market, HSBC says. HSBC technical analyst, and they signal that to cause the plunge. Has thrown up the ultimate warning signal. A note to clients released Wednesday. Murray Gunn, the head of technical analyst for HSBC, said he had become a red alert for an immediate sell-off of stocks given the price action over the past few weeks. Remember 6 weeks ago? We saw similar headlines. Remember 8 months ago? Royal Bank of Scotland, sell everything you've got that's paper. That's the establishment saying that. Almost made me want to buy things, but here's what they know. They want to look like the winners when it all starts going belly up. And basically every major financial institution says this is the season we're in. And the Russians are getting their diplomatic families out of the West. They're canceling diplomatic meetings with heads of state. They're doing 40 million nuclear warfare evacuation drills and saying it's for nuclear war. And the United States, controlled by the globalists, has moved nuclear missiles right up to the border with Russia. And Russia says, what do? I guess we move missiles into Cuba. And we've got a government that wants our military to wear high heels and wants to have trannies as our top commandos. Not to be nice to trannies, folks, but to sabotage the country and have us all in fighting about a man in a dress who's supposedly in high heels going to storm a machine gun nest. While we're debating that, the globalists are about to bring down the whole world. They're moving into their bunkers. I hope this can all be averted, but a telltale sign was 2 years ago. This is now all confirmed when they just said, let anybody in. Any China, Middle East, Asia, Eastern Europe, Latin America. We don't care if they have tuberculosis, this drug immune. It's a death sentence for thousands. Each person you let in with that is thousands that are going to get it. Hundreds will die. The plague, the black plague, bubonic plague, leprosy. It's all back. And it's not like they just let them in. They don't like, oh, you're here with leprosy. Let's treat you. You're here with TB. No, you go, oh, just come on in. You sit back and go, what's the strategy there? One thing. Collapse the country. One thing. That hit me a few weeks ago. I mean, I'm not stupid, but sometimes problems are too obvious to get right away. You know, it's the easier problems that are hard to equate, to deduce, to complete, to transact. What's the right word for doing a math problem? Complete, I guess. They're calling everybody that's against global government, world government, looting and corruption a Russian agent. Because Russia's just one country trying to crawl out of this. And that's because they're going to have a war with Russia and arrest everybody who's their opposition. My God. The problem is you ran this equation in 1917 with a disarmed serf population in Russia. You run it in other countries like China with a disarmed serf population. You're going to run this in the most armed camp in the world with all the ancestral memory to fight you? You take our current weakness and malaise as a sign of weakness? Huh. Okay. If it's what you want, your figurehead can hardly walk. If it's what all you people think you're gods, because you got little fake Iranic glasses and you look like Rachel Maddow and everybody's asexual, so you went to a cool college and you all told each other how smart you were, so you think you're going to win a civil war with us. I'm just going to step aside. I've already done my work at that point. Good luck. That's all I have to tell you. I'll be staying out of the way, but you won't have a prayer. So it won't even matter. Your elites won't even protect you anyways. There's no honor among thieves. Please support the broadcast. Spread the word. It's one of a kind. Thank you for all your support. David Knight is coming in for a fresh 55 minutes of transmission starting now.
Welcome back to the fourth hour of the Alex Jones broadcast. I'm David Knight on this Wednesday, October 12th, 2016. We got a lot of news to cover. Donald Trump really broke down what's behind Hillary Clinton's world government based on these emails that have been leaked from John Podesta, her campaign manager, and comments that have been made at the speeches that she's given to these various banks. We now know, and we have a document that tells you she knows exactly the method that she's going to enact world government, and she defines what world government is. And Donald Trump broke that down for a massive group of supporters yesterday, over 8,000 people that he was speaking to. We're going to talk about that in a moment. We're going to talk about the Fem Dems, which is what I call them, the feminist Democrats, who are really nothing more than the hateful left. as they go out and attack rape victims. We see this throughout the media as well. But before we get into that, I saw this couple of articles on the Drudge Report. I think he put these things right next to each other. Listen to these two headlines. World astrologists gather to predict the president, and then more dead voters and fraud cases discovered in Colorado. So I guess the question is, are CNN and Fox News going to start having seances to poll the dead? Because that's the situation we're in with voter fraud. I mean, they are, it's not just in Colorado, but we're seeing this a lot in Virginia. We've had a couple of different articles, one particular county where they, one person who was working in the county office noticed a name that was going by there that was a deceased judge and said, wait a minute, I know that guy, and he's dead. And he's now registering to vote. What's going on with this? So they started looking at it carefully. They saw a whole bunch of people there. And then we've seen thousands show up in another area of Virginia. And that's only one small area of Virginia. And that's only one state. And as I've pointed out before, I know from secondhand information, a friend of my brother-in-law, who in the last election, 2012, went in to vote. And they said, you've already voted. Because, you know, in North Carolina, there's no voter ID. You can't have a picture ID they can't ask for. All you do is go in and give them a name and an address, and you can vote. And so they said, you voted, and so has this other person at your address. He says, well, that's my mother. She's been dead for a couple of years. So somebody had already gone in and voted for him and for his mother by the time it came to election day, because North Carolina starts voting earlier than any other state in the nation. See, North Carolina was run for a very long time by the Democrats. It's only recently the Republicans have taken over. And they've tried to reform this drawn-out election process, the easy voter registration, the lack of voter ID. They've tried to address that. But every time they say, we're going to look at voter ID, then they come in after them and they say, no, 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 you're not going to do that. That's racist to ask for ID, even though you have to show ID everywhere. So these two articles, one of them is an investigation by CBS in Colorado. The person who was looking at it, the county clerk's office, says, well, I don't think it was an accident. This is part of an investigation done by CBS entitled Dying to Vote. That's the way it breaks out. And then the Guardian story, astrologers are predicting the election. Dozens of astrologers are coming together to predict who will be president. So I guess we're going to see Frank Luntz in with an astrologer, and they're going to be actually doing a Ouija board or whatever to figure out how these dead voters are going to be voting. Because, you know, that's just as scientific as their polls, isn't it? Their polls are just, when you've got polls, they tell you the margin of error is 4 points, and you get one poll after the other that are 8 points apart or 12 points apart, okay? You can't even take the two and add them up and get the margin of error. It's so far apart. When they're heavily skewing it towards Democrat voters, far more than the difference between registered Democrats and registered Republicans. When they don't take into consideration the people who are coming into the election process who haven't voted for many, many years, if ever, because they've been totally fed up with these controlled opposition parties. The Bushes and the Clintons illustrate for us all how there really isn't two different parties. There hasn't really been a choice. It's simply been the American League versus the National League, or the AFC versus the NFC. They're all playing for the same owners. And it's just phony opposition. It is a game. It is a game. And there is some benefit for the people who win, just like there's a benefit for the team that wins the Super Bowl. But you have to understand, they are still going to be controlled. They've got other people who are making the rules. They're going to follow those rules. They're just the faces of this global governance that's there. And I think that when we look at some of these remarks that came out, the speeches that Hillary Clinton was making to these various banking groups, for which she was getting about $250,000 apiece, for which she earned tens of millions of dollars, essentially going to these people and saying, I know precisely what you want. We're on the same page. Give me the money. Put me in office. I'll make it happen. And when we look at this one particular comment here, and Donald Trump, I want to tell you what Donald Trump did to unpack this for his audience, because we've talked about this before. Here's the quote. My dream, she said to a group of bankers, is a hemispheric common market with open trade and open borders sometime in the future, with energy that's as green, as sustainable as we can get it, powering growth and opportunity for every person in the hemisphere. Now, I've said many times, and we've all said here at InfoWars.com, there's three different approaches that they're going to take in order to create a global governance. First of all, you get rid of the borders, and you homogenize the people in one sense to a third world level. You create different, bring in different groups that aren't going to assimilate. That's one of the ways that you destroy the national culture. And so what they're trying to do is homogenize on a international level, make all the countries the same, create conflict with groups that will not assimilate, like the massive groups of Muslims that come in. So that's one part of it, the open borders, okay? And we can see that with the policies like the Dreamer policies and the fact that they go apoplectic. Even Libertarian candidate, Gary Johnson, freaking out when people use the term illegal immigrants. No, there's no such thing as illegals. And we got Nancy Pelosi saying, we don't have borders, we just have one people with a line running through us. It's no different than the border between, let's say, Oklahoma and Texas, because in their mind, they have already created a hemispheric common market. She's just acknowledging what they've been working for a long time. NAFTA was the first part of it. First, you create economic consolidation and economic management. And then what you do is you create political consolidation, okay? And that's what's happening with this. The open borders are part of this. And the other part of it is the what they call open trade or free trade. That really is not free trade. It's really managed trade. And we've talked about that as well. That's what TPP and the TTIP, the Transatlantic, the Trans-Pacific Partnerships. And understand, they don't even call them trade agreements anymore. NAFTA was a treaty. They don't call it a treaty. They called it a trade agreement. But it was a treaty. TPP is a treaty. So is TTIP. Those are both treaties. And yet, the reality is that they want to call them something other than a treaty, so they don't have to follow the constitutional process for ratifying a treaty. But you have to understand, this isn't about free trade. It's not about open trade. This is about having our economy managed by a committee, an international committee that is not elected, that is not accountable to anyone. Okay? This is worse than the central planning committee of the communist countries that would get together and do the economic planning with a five-year plan. This is precisely how these trade agreements were created in the first place. And as Senator Sessions pointed out, the only senator to go in and really read and study and analyze and present what these treaties were about, it is a living document. It creates a committee that can, by fiat, change anything in it, including the people who are included in it. They can bring in China. This is not a bulwark against China. And as Jeff Sessions pointed out, they are going to be managing our economy. Nobody is going to be electing these people. How do they get appointed? Ask yourself. Well, ask yourself who wrote these agreements. Your elected representatives in every one of these countries affected, not just in America, but all of the countries. The elected representatives couldn't even look at this stuff. And then they're told afterwards, and these are the people, Paul Ryan, Mitch McConnell, all these people who are dumping on Trump, who say they can't support him. They're not going to do anything to help him. They're not supporting America. These are the same people who, after they were hand-delivered this agreement that was created by a few multinational corporations lobbyists, they said, we're going to ram this thing through without any kind of debate, without filibuster, without delay. It's going, once they present this thing, it's going to run through in 20 days. There will be no amendments, no debate about any of this stuff. Just going to be a straight up and down vote, and it's going to be a majority vote, not a two-thirds vote like is required in the Constitution. So we have the open borders. We have the so-called open trade, which is globalist management of your economy. And then we have the sustainable aspect, the climate treaty. This is what Hillary Clinton finishes up with. Oh, we're going to be green and sustainable. You understand that is perhaps the most powerful aspect of global governance. Look at the UN agenda for 2030 of sustainable development. Okay, what they're talking about there is essentially creating a global tax that is going to fund a global governance. You have to have a global problem that a global government is going to address. So they invented climate change. And then they invented a crony capitalist system to do this, which is also a tax, which will fund this global governance by these multinational corporations that are writing these treaties. All three of those things are right there in Hillary Clinton's remarks. Now, here's the way Donald Trump broke it down yesterday. First of all, he said, we have to investigate Hillary Clinton, and we have to investigate the investigation. In other words, we've got to find out, and we're going to find out. He knows that Comey and Lynch were coordinating with the Clinton campaign. We see now more emails confirming that, but we told you that before. We told you about the relationship between Comey and between Lynch. Now, that's been going on for a long time, that they let Sandy Berger get away with destroying national security documents in a cover-up, that they've been working together and for the Clintons for a very long time, those two people. When we come back, we're going to break down Donald Trump's remarks about global governance. He nailed it precisely with this crowd last night. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. And before we get back to what Donald Trump said, breaking down how Hillary Clinton has literally defined world government for us and how we're going to get there. Before we do that, I want to just remind you that we've extended for one final day the special on DNA Force. That's 23% off at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, DNA Force is our special formulation with BioPQQ. It's backed by 175 clinical studies, very hard to secure, very expensive to produce. Just one ingredient, that one ingredient costs $30,000 per batch to run through. But, of course, that's not all that it has. It also has very powerful things like CoQ10, digestive enzymes, resveratrol, many other things that are in the DNA Force. But, of course, that is a key ingredient. It makes it very expensive for us to produce, as well as difficult to produce. And a 23% discount is a huge discount. Right now, you can get that at InfoWarsLife.com, 23% off DNA Force. Today is the last day that that will be discounted. Also, a new sale, a flash sale today. Knockout Sleep Support, 25% off at InfoWarsLife.com. This is a lot of natural ingredients, safe ingredients that will help you get a good night's rest. Valerian root extract, melatonin, chamomile flower extract, L-tryptophan, and many other key ingredients. That last one, L-tryptophan. You know, that's what's in turkey that makes you sleepy on Thanksgiving Day. So that's a lot of natural ingredients, and that really works. I tell you, when I take that, when I'm having difficulty sleeping, I take Knockout Sleep Support, and that really does the trick. Gives me a very restful night's sleep. Right now, 25% off a flash sale at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, I want to go back to this speech that Donald Trump gave yesterday. This was in Florida Tuesday night. He had about 8,000 people. As I mentioned before we went to the break, he said, we have to investigate Hillary Clinton. We have to investigate the investigation, he said. And he went on to call her a carpetbagging U.S. senator from New York. Yeah, that's exactly what she is. She's gone both different directions. She's carpetbagging going from north to south and from south to north. He said, by the time the crowd estimated at 8,000 filed back to their cars, this is Daily Mail, he had accused her of secretly plotting to eliminate America's national borders in favor of a single global government with control over trade and immigration. Now, you have to understand, he didn't accuse her of this. What he read was her statement saying that that is her dream, that is her goal, and laying out the three tactics to achieve that, just as I pointed that out in the last segment. And then he goes on to say this, speaking in secret to a foreign bank, again, just revealed, Hillary said, my dream is a hemispheric common market with open trade, open borders. And he quoted a digest of previously undisclosed transcripts of speeches. These are the things that came out on Friday that were so damaging to Hillary Clinton that they came out with this locker room talk that Donald Trump had, the tape. And that's all that they wanted to talk about. That was the red herring. So you wouldn't pay attention to so many of the things that Hillary Clinton, that came out about Hillary Clinton in these speeches. He says, well, there goes the rest of your businesses, folks. There goes your country, folks. He said, behind closed doors, this is Donald Trump talking about Hillary Clinton's admission that she wants a hemispheric open trade, open borders. She wants a common market. She wants a North American Union. The North American Union that they always told us was a fantasy of the conspiracy theorists. No, she laid it out there in detail. And it's not going to stop with the North American Union. It's not going to stop with the European Union. They are combining those together with the TTIP, just as they are combining America with a governance of our economy with the TPP with Asian countries. He goes on. He says, behind closed doors, when she thought no one was listening, She pledged to dissolve the borders of the United States of America. No borders. And he goes on to say, if you don't have borders, you don't have a country. He said, WikiLeaks has given us a window into the secret corridors of government power where we see a former Secretary of State announcing her desire to end forever the American independence that our founders gave us and wanted us to have. He said, we're protecting the borders of foreign countries, but not our borders. Think about that. Think about the fact that we have our government all over the world fighting wars that have multiplied under the Obama administration, multiplied under Hillary Clinton's Secretary of State administration. We have set the Middle East on fire. We're abroad protecting the borders of foreign countries, said Donald Trump, but nobody is protecting our borders. These WikiLeaks emails confirm what those of us here today have known all along, he continued. Hillary Clinton is the vessel of a corrupt globalist establishment that's raiding our country, surrendering the sovereignty of our nation. This criminal government cartel doesn't recognize borders, but believes in global governance, unlimited immigration, and rule by corporations. The few multinational corporations that have written the TPP and the TTIP and are handing it down to our people like Paul Ryano, who will rubber stamp it through with a non-constitutional process. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. You know, it's interesting to see the article saying that the Clinton campaign is losing patience with Bill Clinton rape protesters. Yeah, I bet they are. There's been five of them just today. This thing is going totally viral, and they are freaking out. Look at the way the Fem Dems, the hateful left, are replying to this. We've got yesterday Joy Behar on The View suggesting this line for Hillary Clinton regarding those women. She said, I would like to apologize to those tramps that have slept with my husband. Oh, there you go. Calling them tramps. Okay, this is blurring the line, deliberately blurring the line between rape and consensual sex. Okay, Bill Clinton has had a lot of consensual sex. But what we're talking about with Juanita Broderick and others is rape. You have to understand the difference. And these feminists who say they're all about women, no, they're about Hillary Clinton. Hillary Clinton is not about women. Hillary Clinton is for herself. She's not with you. If you're with her, you're being duped into voting for a phony feminist who hates women, who get in her way and will destroy them by any means necessary, including covering up for her raping husband. Now, Joy Behar then apologized the next show and says, I never intended to belittle sexual assault and the women who are victims. Oh, really? Oh, really? So you just call them tramps? Isn't that usually the tactic that is taken against women who are accuse someone of rape? They're always attacked as tramps, aren't they, Joy? People like you have always attacked and destroyed the character of people who come out and talk about rape. That's what we saw with the guy who just did Birth of a Nation, Nate Parker, and his the other guy that was with him. Both of them were accused of rape. The other guy was convicted and eventually let off on a technicality on appeal, just like Hillary Clinton began her political career. That's the way she began her political career, getting off a child rapist on a technicality and cackling about it. We've all heard the tape, haven't we? But Joy Behar says, well, I wouldn't want to ever belittle sexual assault. Well, you just did. You just did. You just belittled multiple people who have been sexually assaulted by a serial rapist because it gets in the way of your political ambitions for the person that you really care about, Hillary Clinton. You don't care about women in general. You don't care about women's rights. And that includes Whoopi Goldberg as well. They blurred the line on Monday's broadcast of The View. They blurred the lines between women who had had consensual affairs with Mr. Clinton and those who accused him of sexual assault. And then she comes back and says, well, I want to apologize for that. Well, it's a bit too late, I think. And that was an article from the Washington Times. Look at what happened then on CNN. Here's another one of the Fem Dems, another one of the hateful left. CNN panelists, this is on Infowars.com. Bill Clinton rape allegations are effing ridiculous, dude. She just goes off on a rant, swearing, you know, using harmful language that we're supposed to get upset about, you know, like Donald Trump. CNN panelist dismissed Bill Clinton's documented history of sexual abuse against women as effing ridiculous, dude. on a broadcast of Aaron Burnett out front. Yeah, you're out front, all right. As the networks continue to cover for the Clintons while devoting vast swaths of airtime to Trump's locker room banter tape from 2005. This is an article by Steve Watson. He writes, the person who said this was Angela Rye. She went absolutely crazy, almost yelled obscenities when the conservative member of the panel brought up documented accounts of Hillary Clinton's attacks on the women who have accused Bill Clinton of sexual abuse. No, she didn't. She, what? How did she facilitate it when she wasn't? She goes on and on with this and just freaks out. If you look at the transcript, she says no five times and no, because it's rape culture, Kaylee. You're blaming someone who succumbed to committing adultery on her. We're Christians, so let's talk about what this is, okay? So this is the way this is rolling over and over again. They absolutely can't handle this, and this campaign is going viral. But take a look at the other ways. This is always the way the left handles everything, with censorship, with punishment. Look at Canada, for example. We have a European Parliament member. Go to Canada. He's a French activist. He's an anti-globalization activist. His name is José Bové, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. He was told to leave Canada by today, preventing him from speaking at an event that would oppose a planned EU-Canada free trade deal. See, it isn't just the TTIP. It isn't things just like NAFTA, TPP, and others. The Canadians have their own free trade deal, which is consolidating all this. And it is not simply because they don't want free trade and open markets. It isn't about free trade and open markets. And when the Republicans or libertarians tell you that it's about free trade, you really are being deceived. You really need to look at this. It's about so much more than even the economics behind it. It's also about the freedom of the internet. And it's also about the freedom to make your own laws about the environment. Now, I would disagree with this guy. He's a green candidate. I would disagree with him, but I think we ought to be able to make that decision with elected representatives country by country, not have that decision made for us by some corporate global entity that is going to dictate the terms of our economy to us and tell us precisely who's going to be allowed to have factories and who isn't, and how those factories are going to be fueled and how they're not going to be fueled. It was a Council of Canadians, listen to this, a social justice nonprofit. It's always the social justice people, right? It's the social justice people who scream in your face, just like this person yesterday on CNN. They just get in your face and scream and shut you down, censor you, take you off the air, and shout you down. They denied entry to this guy ahead of a public forum that the group had organized on the Canadian-EU Comprehensive Economic Trade Agreement, CETA. See, it's happening everywhere. They don't want debate. They don't want people to know what this is. So they shut you down. They deport you. And that's what they're doing. They're actually throwing this guy out of the country. Out of the country. And he's coming from the this is a trade deal between the EU and Canada. And he's coming back and saying, let me tell you why you don't want to surrender your authority to some transnational committee. And they said, you're leaving the country. We're throwing you out. You're not even going to be allowed to talk about this. This is what we're seeing everywhere. As Donald Trump was saying yesterday, and let me read this quote to you again, because I think this is key. This is like his it's Americanism versus globalism statement. This is what he had to say. He said, Hillary Clinton is a vessel of a corrupt global establishment. I'll read this to you again. It's raiding our country, surrendering the sovereignty of our nation. The criminal government cartel doesn't recognize borders, but believes in global governance, unlimited immigration, and rule by corporations. You understand? It's a global government ruled by corporations, and they don't believe in borders. And here's more evidence of this. The feds will press criminal contempt charges against Sheriff Arpaio. Okay, the federal government has charged Sheriff Arpaio, says the RT, with criminal contempt charges for violating a judge's order to stop immigration patrols. All right? Now, if convicted, he could spend 6 months in jail. So here's the situation. We're going to jail law enforcement. We're going to jail the people who try to enforce our border laws. We've already had Obama handcuff, metaphorically handcuff the Border Patrol. Now they are going to literally jail Sheriff Arpaio for patrolling the borders. That's why the Border Patrol supports Donald Trump. That's why Sheriff Arpaio supports Donald Trump. He's trying to enforce the law that Barack Obama doesn't care about. And Barack Obama is shutting down law enforcement, is going to jail this sheriff. And the group that is protesting the sheriff, their slogan here is arrest Arpaio, not the people. Well, if the people are here illegally and if they're violating our laws, they need to be arrested. You don't arrest someone who is enforcing our laws. But that's the way the Obama administration has turned this upside down. And as they were doing this, this group saying arrest the sheriff, not the people. Okay, arrest Arpaio, not the people. Okay, they're chanting outside the courthouse, a couple of dozen protesters in Spanish. They're chanting, yes, we can. Yes, we can. See, it's Obama that is destroying our country, and it is his work that is going to be continued by Hillary Clinton. And you have to understand that it is for the benefit of the banks. This is precisely what they're doing. Now, we had Hillary Clinton come out, and we've talked about the fact that she said that we are going to have appropriate responses to cyber hacking. We're going to have political and economic and military responses to cyber hacking. Think about that for a moment. When you look at all of these wild conspiracy theories that were thrown out about how it was the Russians who were releasing information that embarrassed Hillary Clinton at the Democrat National Convention, when you look at every time something comes out, they say the Russians did it, the Russians did it. Okay, they have not proved that. And even if that were true, you and I would never be able to vet that. It is the ultimate false flag if you're going to use that to start a war. And understand that when you create economic sanctions against a country, that is the first stage towards war. And that's what we're doing right now against Russia. But they're talking about military strikes in response to cyber hacks. Do you realize how dangerous that is? That is the ultimate false flag technique. We have to take their word that there was a cyber hack in the first place. We don't even know in some of these cases if they say, well, somebody hacked into our personnel files or whatever, and federal government got all of our federal employees' personnel files. So we don't know for sure that happened. We're taking their word for it that it happened. We certainly don't have any way to validate who did that. But they can say something happened, and then they can finger the Russians for it, and then they can start a military response. And now we have Obama doubling down on that. He says he's going to consider proportional responses to Russian hacking, threatening them. Again, they're escalating this, okay, saying, oh, you keep releasing information about us. And again, I don't believe that this information is coming from Russia. Neither did Bill Binney, former technical director of the NSA. He believes that it's people inside the intelligence community, inside the military, who are doing this because they're concerned about what Hillary Clinton and Obama are doing. They know what's being discussed behind closed doors. They know how they're trying to take this country down. They know how they've betrayed intelligence officers, probably cost them their lives with her careless actions, as Comey called it. Actually, there are multiple felonies, violation of national security. So they're very concerned about what's going to happen with this. And so they want the American public to know. And I think whoever is doing this is a hero, just like Ed Snowden was a hero. They always attack and try to kill the messenger, try to distract you from seeing the information and label these people. But now what they're doing is they're constantly blaming the Ruskies, going toe-to-toe with the Ruskies and about to do nuclear combat toe-to-toe with the Ruskies. Obama will consider a proportional response to recent hacks conducted by Russia. They say, we will obviously ensure that a U.S. response is proportional, but it's unlikely that our response will be announced in advance. It's certainly possible the president could choose response options that we never announce. So, we could have a cyber hack that we can't even verify was a cyber hack. They can then blame it on Russia, and we have no way of verifying that. And they can do it after they've already attacked Russia or done something. So they say, we're not going to announce in advance what we're going to do. We're just going to do something. And they are threatening Russia with this, whether Russia is behind this or not. They are going to blame Russia, and they're going to try to use this as an excuse to escalate war. Russia is very concerned about this. They just had a civil defense bill, a drill that was 40 million people, hundreds of thousands of government officers were moving people around. Of course, we don't ever have anything like that here in America because, first of all, Americans don't think that nuclear war could ever touch us. We've never been touched by war here in America, and so they don't think that it could happen. It's very foolish, isn't it? But, of course, even during the height of the Cold War, there was never any civil defense program created by our government. It was the Russians that did that to try to protect their people. Here in America, the only people that we really worry about protecting are those at the very top. They get underground bunkers to protect them. But if you want it, you're on your own. You can go out and buy a bunker like people were doing back in the 1950s and 60s. And when you do it, they're going to laugh at you for doing that and trying to take care of yourself. That's funny. Anyway, they say the posting of thousands of emails from political officials on sites like DCLeaks.com and WikiLeaks, as they say, from the Homeland Security, these thefts and disclosures are intended to interfere with the U.S. election process. Oh, yeah. Okay. Who's interfering with the election process? Well, they say it's Russia, and so they're talking about how they're going to attack Russia. They're taking it very seriously. Washington Examiner says former Soviet leader Gorbachev says U.S.-Russia tension has reached a dangerous point. He said that ending talks between the two world powers was the biggest mistake. See, think about the fact that throughout the GOP primaries, when we had debates, everybody was beating on Donald Trump for saying that he would talk to the Russians. Remember that? Remember Carly Fiorina? I wouldn't talk to them. I'd just show them how strong I am. I'd do something to them first. And that's what Obama is saying. That's what Hillary Clinton is saying. That's what the mainstream media is saying. Don't talk to these Ruskies. Just drop a bomb on them or something. You know, declare a no-fly zone in Syria, says General Petraeus and other generals. And it isn't going to cost us anything. We can take down all their planes and to shoot down the Russian planes with cruise missiles. That is insane. That is insane. That is truly mutual assured destruction, the revival of the Cold War, but even pushing it further, I think, in terms of language. And, of course, this is in response to Secretary of State John Kerry threatening to stop all talks, all cooperation with Russia in the region, unless Russia ends its bombing of Aleppo in support of Syrian President Bashar Assad, okay? Understand that they're not, when they support Assad, who are they fighting? Well, that would be ISIS, wouldn't it? So Secretary of State John Kerry says, if you don't stop fighting ISIS, we're going to stop talking to you. We are going to take action against you. That's the reality. Meanwhile, Russia is escalating things, creating their own no-fly zone in Syria. Remember, Russia was invited in by the Syrian government that Obama and Hillary were determined to overthrow, just as they overthrew Gaddafi in Libya and created what there? What do we have there? What do we have in Iraq where we did the same thing? Do we have peace, stability? Are things better off? We've been to war twice in Iraq, and now we have continual fighting in that area, as well as Libya being turned into an arms bazaar for ISIS and Al-Qaeda. Well, the Russians were invited in by the Syrian government. They have now said on their own that they're going to have a no-fly zone because they've been invited in there by the government. We are there in support of the rebels. And now Russian senators are backing a permanent deployment of the Russian Air Force to Syria. This is out of RT. They say Russian senators have ratified an agreement that allows permanent deployment of the country's Air Force in Syria, solidifying Moscow's projection of power in the Middle East. If their policy isn't suicidal, it is short-sighted, isn't it? We'll be right back. Stay with us.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. Before we get back to the news, I just want to remind you that we have a flash sale on Knockout Sleep Support. 25% off at InfoWarsLife.com. It's a great natural product. I have used this in the past. It has no lingering effects, but boy, it really gives you a sound night's sleep. When you really need to get a sound night's sleep, this is a great natural way to do it. 25% off right now, just today, flash sale at InfoWarsLife.com. Also ending today is our sale on DNA Force, 23% off. And as we pointed out, this is a very expensive product to produce, and so a 23% discount is a huge savings that you can take advantage of. This is your last day to get 23% off DNA Force. It contains BioPQQ,
backed by 175 clinical studies, very hard to secure, very expensive to produce, $30,000 per batch just for that one ingredient. And, of course, there's other very helpful ingredients in that as well. Again, 23% off is a big discount, a big savings, and you can get that at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, in the time that we have left, I want to take a look at an AP story here. Why do evangelicals prefer Donald Trump to Hillary Clinton? As they point out, in light of this tape that was released to draw people's attention away from the emails on Hillary Clinton, they say cracks have appeared in evangelical support for Trump, but backing from some of the most high-profile conservative Christian endorsers is holding. And I want to take a look at three different approaches to this. First of all, there's a well-known theologian, Wayne Grudem, who came out and said, I'm unendorsing Donald Trump at this point. He had endorsed him before, said, you have to understand that we can make some real, have a real effect by electing Donald Trump versus Hillary Clinton. He had said that before. But now when he saw these responses, he comes out and has what I believe is a knee-jerk reaction. Wayne Grudem says he's the very embodiment of what the Bible calls a fool. I don't agree with that. And neither does James Dobson of Family Talk Radio. He said that he doesn't like Trump's comments, but he said you have to understand that Hillary Clinton's support for abortion rights is criminal. He said Mr. Trump promises to support religious liberty and the dignity of the unborn. Mrs. Clinton promises that she will not. You have to understand, she is against your religious liberty, and she is against life. She's not pro-life, and you have to understand there is a real choice here. Setting out this election is not a moral choice. Sorry, Glenn Beck, it isn't. You can sit there and pontificate, you know, in your sweater and tell people that the moral choice is not to vote for either one of them. No, you're going to get one of them. And you can make a legitimate difference here. You can either have a situation where you have to fight Hillary Clinton on every single issue, not only Hillary Clinton, but the Republican establishment and the Democrat establishment and the media establishment on every single issue. And you're going to lose your country to a globalist government. But you're going to lose, first of all, your religious liberty. So think about that, Christians. And then, of course, Jerry Falwell Jr., we've talked about this before, he's the one, I think, that understands it the most. He understands that, okay, these comments, he said, were reprehensible. But he also understands that not only do we have a clear choice between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump, he said, we're never going to have a perfect candidate. But he also suggested that the video leak was engineered by Trump's enemies in his own party. You understand this is the Bushes doing it for the Clintons. He said, I think it was timed. I think it might have been a conspiracy, you know, among the establishment Republicans who've known about it for weeks, who tried to time it so that it could do the maximum damage. That's precisely what is going on. He understands the technique that they're using here. And he understands what is truly at stake. There is a real, clear, distinguishing difference between the two of them, and it's going to make a very big difference which one of them is president. Join us tonight for the InfoWars Nightly News at 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern. I'll be hosting.